Brida maid of Reddit who was involved in a Bridazilla wedding. What happened? Bride was blonde. All bridesmaids except for me were brunette. She asked me to dye my hair brown for the wedding because she wanted to be the only blonde. I suggested that instead I just give up my bridesmaid spot. Thankful to this day since I heard the dresses and bachelorette party cost all the other girls more money than I make in a month. I like your style. I was almost in a Bridazilla wedding. I had an ectopic pregnancy, baby attached to my tube, which then burst, and I almost bleed to death. She got engaged shortly following my ectopic. When she asked me to be her bridesmaid, she told me that I would be required to wait to try to have another baby until after her wedding in 1.5 years. Not because there would be a small child at the wedding. Not even because she didn't want me fat at her wedding. But because if I lost another child, it would take away from her engagement and wedding. I was so shocked I just declined and have never spoken to her since. Update. My cousin is on Reddit. She wrote me a scathing email about how mean everyone was to her, and I needed to update this and tell everyone it was her second wedding and she wanted it to be special this around. Also, I needed to defend her. Instead, hi Jessica. Keep sending this to grandma. I really don't care. Frick that lady. I'm sorry you went through that. I'm honestly shocked there's people out there who think it's okay to talk out loud like that. This was my sister's wedding, so hold on tight. My sister had 10 bridesmaids. Most of them were her sorority sisters from college. They wanted to plan an elaborate weekend for the summer, while most of them were still in school without jobs. When I asked, hey, who'll pay for this, my sister got pissed that I even asked. When I also reminded all the bridesmaids them that our father who had stage 4 cancer wasn't doing so well and that maybe the bachelorette bridal shower should be close by, they all flipped thinking I was being insensitive to the bride. I was promptly asked not to be a bridesmaid to my own sister's wedding over these two things. I was fine with this as she was a Bridazilla and I spent time with our dying father. He died 2 weeks after her wedding day, that he couldn't attend because he was in hospice care one day before her wedding. To me, she put herself before our ailing father, and it still makes me mad. I'm sorry about your dad. I'm glad you got to be with him instead. Bridesmaid to a Bridazilla here. The bride spent a lot of time crying and carrying on whenever she didn't get her way because it was her wedding and we should all do exactly what she wanted. Which is not to say we did and we sure did. She wanted everyone to justify her irrational and horrible behavior because it was all about her. She didn't enjoy it much when I told her she was wrong for kicking someone out of her bridal party, terminating the friendship, and pitching a fit because the girl couldn't make bridesmaid dress shopping because she was sick and had to go to the hospital. This is also coming from the same woman who got angry and didn't speak to me for months because I didn't come see her to congratulate her on her pregnancy when I was home on furlough for a week at Christmas. My wife's best friend is a florist by trade, gifted her services to decorate her friend's wedding. Big cost savings. Wedding goes as planned, all is good. Afterwards, bride and bride's mom get pissy at florist friend who didn't give a gift in the wedding card. Didn't even cover her husband's plate, let's conveniently forget the $1,000 in floral products gifted to the wedding. It's a rift that never healed between them since. WTF. My mom and I shrugged off the people who didn't bring gifts. Their presence was a gift. But I didn't marry my mom. I married my husband. I had a silent Bridazilla. She was my best friend of 15 years and didn't ask for much at all through the wedding planning as there was only 2 months between engagement and the wedding day. No bachelorette party, no dress shopping, no gift giving, no meeting up in person to do anything. We lived 2 hours drive away from each other, didn't want my input, just wanted me to be there and go find my own dress and look pretty. Okay, whatever you want, you're my bestie and I'm excited you're getting married. On the day I wasn't allowed to help with hair and makeup, just had to focus on my own. Apparently I couldn't be trusted to do it well enough as I have short hair. Okay fine, it's your day, whatever. Crap went down afterwards where she got her sister, the maid of honor and also my close friend for 15 years, to call me up in a 2-hour phone call and criticize my every little move throughout the entire wedding and say that I should never had accepted to be a bridesmaid if I didn't want to participate. And had gone through my Facebook page and noted down, page and noted down, page and noted down, page and noted down. Look at my new bowling ball. I've joined a bowling league for fun. and said how I should have spent that money on the wedding instead. The wedding was set 2 days after Christmas, and her family didn't even celebrate that Christmas that year because of the wedding. And I was criticized for not spending more time with her, even though the day after Christmas I took a 3-hour train trip just to hang with her the night before her wedding. Apparently I should have stayed the night if the wedding to hang with the other two bridesmaids, but I opted to drive home with my boyfriend as I need to work. She said from the start she was going to pay for makeup to be done on the day, then 2 weeks before said I needed to drive 2 hours to go buy a specific brand for myself to wear that was really expensive, which I did, even though I was broke from Christmas shopping, but apparently I had some attitude about it. Then I was criticized for not giving a gift, despite being told being a bridesmaid was gift enough. The bride herself just stopped talking to me, blocked me on Facebook, and after months of bulls I just cut them both out of my life. I haven't seen either of them since the wedding day, which was now 5 years ago. Never even got to see the wedding photos. Sad that long-term friendships end over nothing. If she had expectations, say something. Don't expect me to guess then judge me for failing your expectations and be too chicken crap to talk to me about it directly. My dad had the audacity to die 6 weeks before the wedding, and she couldn't understand why that superseded her wedding details for me. I met my husband at her wedding, haven't spoken to her since. I couldn't attend my friend's last minute destination wedding because I had to visit my dad out of state to handle hospice arrangements. He was dying of cancer. She threw an absolute hissy fit, attempting to guilt trip me because I couldn't afford to make 2 plane flights. That was the end of our friendship. My ex-best friend was a trip. This story is just one of the many, many reasons I no longer speak to her. She tried to make me and another bridesmaid walk down her outdoor, uneven, teal-covered aisle without glasses. She told us the morning of the event, so we didn't have any time to get contacts or anything. She threw an hysterics fit because she was convinced that we would ruin the aesthetic of her wedding. I told her that she would have a single groomsman walking that aisle if she made me walk without them. She started bawling, but her mom was able to get her calmed down enough for her to agree to let us wear our glasses so we could actually make it down the aisle in one piece. Her mom essentially said that she's more skinny and beautiful than either of us and no one would be glancing at her bridesmaids anyways because we aren't important. Gee, I wonder where she gets it. When she eventually messages you to sell you unique, tell her I said to go frick her hat. A friend of mine in college was getting married at 19 because she was super conservative Christian and she wanted to frick. Between the time I agreed to be a bridesmaid and a couple of months before the wedding I lost some weight. She got super pee at me because she wanted to be the skinny one on the stage and threw me out of the wedding party. Oh well. She's got messed up priorities. Good riddance. Not a bridesmaid, but my mom was a wedding photographer for many years. Long story short, the father of the bride had a heart attack and as he was being carried out on the stretcher the sobbing bride yells, "How could you ruin my wedding like this?" Maybe he faked it to get out of there. It was a best friend of mine who was very frugal, so I figured she was going to have a reasonable wedding and bachelorette party. I had shared my monetary concerns with her too, that I worked and went to school and couldn't take off much time. She didn't have that many friends so it was only me and one other girl as bridesmaids. She asked us to hand make all her decorations for the wedding. I put in 15 hours a week hand making decorations, all outside of working and going to school full time. Then she planned a week-long bachelorette party out of town, also asking us to foot the bill, not to mention our dresses which I wanted to find something affordable. But she picked designer matching dresses that we had to pay for, never worn it again, been trying to sell it online. I spent nearly 1k on the whole ordeal, not to mention I did her hair and makeup for free for the wedding. I just felt largely taken advantage of and unappreciated. We are no longer friends because we ended up working together after the wedding, and she tried to screw me over at work. It all makes me very reluctant to agree to be in someone's wedding again, even someone I thought would be considerate of everyone else's budget and time. So she pretty much treated you like a GoFundMe. That's terrible. The short story is that she lied. She lied to the venue about the number of guests that were attending, effectively packing us like sardines. She lied about having a day of staff. That meant that all the dates of the bridesmaids spent the day hanging flowers, running to get kegs and waters, pouring the champagne for guests, setting up the entire venue the day before. She lied to the hair and makeup personnel about the number of people who were obtaining services in order to get them to come to the site. This forced guests to get hair and makeup done in order for the bride not to have to be charged extra. She lied to the catering about the number of guests. This caused them to run out of food and alcohol. All in all, I think her lies saved her $1,500, but cost her close friendships as her attitude toward the whole situation was indignation instead of being apologetic. If you can't afford a big wedding, then don't have a big wedding. Ugh. That's why I'm getting married in the courthouse and having a party. LOL. I didn't make it to the wedding. I was best friends with the woman. Literally, we did everything together. She assembled her wedding party and didn't invite me. She threw me my bachelorette, witnessed my marriage, etc. I found out later I wasn't invited because I was overweight and her mother thought that would limit bridesmaid dress choices and throw the wedding photos off. At least I know. Dodge a bullet. My first job out of college, a colleague got engaged and asked three colleagues to be her bridesmaids. In addition to one friend from high school, I had only known her for a matter of months, but I didn't feel comfortable saying no because she was one of my bosses. In addition to being in a wedding for someone I barely knew, which is crappy in its own right, there were so many horrible things about this nightmare Bridezilla wedding. First, I ended up hosting both her bachelorette and her shower because no one in her life planned anything, and she showed up to her own shower an hour late, hungover and wearing pajamas when she mandated that everyone dress for a luncheon. She ordered our dresses from Etsy, as opposed to any bridesmaid dress company, and they looked like seafoam green raw silk pillowcases with holes cut for the arms and head. They tied in giant bows in the back and we all looked like literal infants. She wouldn't let us wear heels with said dresses because the groom was kinda short and we all had to buy new flats in a specific shade of gold. She wanted us to wear our hair in a really ugly, extremely complicated updo, and said we would have to pay to have one of the hairstylists do our hair. We refused. The wedding was on a Sunday in an extremely inconvenient and far away location, and it was not the Sunday of a long weekend. The rehearsal dinner for this Sunday wedding was Thursday and started at 4 in the afternoon, requiring everyone to leave work in the middle of the day. She forced us to stay at an expensive hotel in the area the night before the wedding for no apparent reason and refused to pay for our hotel room. Fun times. And that's why she has no friends and had to have work colleagues she barely knows in her wedding. Cringy. Bride had two weddings. Pretty different financial backgrounds between us, and I was friend of the groom that became a friend during their engagement. She had one wedding in the local state she grew up and one destination wedding a month later. She couldn't decide which dress to get, so she bought three. I was maid of honor at the local event and supposed to be in the destination wedding. Had to overdraw my bank account to attend and cover expenses, so I was really a bit in awe at all the extravagances. It was a 3-hour ceremony with two venue changes. I want what I want and it's my day. I gave people for that still ringing in my ears just thinking of it. She spent 60k in credit card debt on her perfect day, s, which she told me the day before she had not informed the groom. The best part was when she was in her second wedding dress change. She started to scream about how things weren't exactly what she wanted, standing there half dressed and drunk yelling about how the cake wasn't perfect. 3k cake that was transported from another state was slightly smushed on the backside from hours of travel. The whole bridal party was just standing there in the hallway waiting to take pictures again. I told her to shut up, said I wasn't going to come to wedding in Ireland, reminded her that her hundreds of guests could hear her drunk butt, and fixed her bustle. She was such a little tantrum throwing crap. At the end of the Irish dancing groups, the toasts, and her wedding dance, that was choreographed. Her paid wedding planner offered to give me C for putting up with such a spoiled crap. The lady did it loudly in front of the aunt who later told the bride, yeah, it sucked. She is a great girl too. Just a terrible bride and drunk. TL;DR wedding planner offered me drugs for putting up with the bride. My best friend just got kicked out of being a bridesmaid because she couldn't spend the $1,500 to go to the bachelorette's party. All the other costs were killing her. The bride told her to take out a credit card to pay for it. One of our friends made the best comment over the situation. She, the bride, just did you the best favor ever kicking you out of the bridal party. Not a Bridezilla story, but I was in 3 weddings in the span of 1 year, and one interesting thing I noticed was that there is always one bridesmaid that the bride stops being friends with after the wedding. You can start to see which bridesmaid it's gonna be about halfway through the engagement. My mom was the bride. She didn't have bridesmaids, but I, her daughter, was going to walk her down the aisle. I've had purple or blue hair for quite some time, and I checked almost a year in advance with my mom that it would be okay for my hair to be blue for the wedding. I checked again every few months. Every time I was told to stop insinuating that she was a Bridezilla. Of course my hair was fine. 2 weeks before the wedding, my own mother threatened to disinvite me from the wedding if I didn't fix my hair. So I went and got it done. Came home and my mother told me I was shallow for changing my hair to keep up appearances. Sigh. Getting it ray dyed back to blonde cost me over $300. Friend asked me to be a bridesmaid in her shotgun wedding that was to take place in a little over a month. She has us order semi-expensive dresses and they had to be altered to a certain length. Shoes had to be ordered. Toenails had to be painted neutral color and fingernails had to be French manicure. We weren't allowed to paint our own nails, we had to get them done at a salon. Hair had to be done professionally by her hairstylist. And we were not, under any circumstance, to have bikini tan lines visible. Mind you, this was right after summer. I lived in an area where beach attire was usually the only attire and everyone had visible tan lines. I eventually had to tell her that I could not afford to have everything done professionally with such short notice. I would be happy to do my hair and makeup. My hair was so short I couldn't do an updo. She told me her mom could pay and then I could pay her back. That was the final straw. I sent an email to her telling her I could no longer be in her wedding. She was pregnant, about to get hitched, and now I was adding to her list of problems. I valued the friendship and told her such, but just couldn't do what she was asking. I hadn't heard from her for years, until one day she sent me a message, asking for me to buy from her MLM campaign. FFS. MLM is multi-level marketing. FFS is for frick's sake. I was planning on rolling up to this wedding dressed as a zebra in a bunny suit with 6-day-old and washed bedhead and smeared mascara. Not the case. I'm more than willing to do what it takes to look the part and be part of her special day. But having ridiculous demands and expecting for your bridesmaid to pay quite a bit for it on such short notice is what got me. The email that I sent her was polite and really hammered home the point that I could not afford what she was asking. Either she'd have to be okay and trust that I wouldn't look like the Babadook, or that I could back out of the wedding so that she wouldn't have to stress. I wasn't mad at her. Things happened way too fast and she had no time to plan. I get it. I don't have any hard feelings towards her. Yes. I posted to AntimlMLOL. You did the smart thing. And quite frankly, that seems really rare after having read through these stories. If you can't afford something, the answer is to tell the bride your request is not possible because I can't afford it. I was the maid of honor. I helped plan the whole wedding. I went to all the awkward parties with family members I had never met. I was close with the bride and groom, not their families. The whole time we were planning she kept talking about being a Bridezilla like it was an inevitable phase she would go through. FFW all the way to the end. She suddenly decided that her sister needs to be the only one involved, but I can still be the maid of honor. She calls me the day of the bridal shower and asks why I wasn't there and insists she told me the date. She hadn't. She fires me on the spot and I don't talk to her again until a few days before the wedding. She tells me that I can still come but she had asked one of her husband's ex-girlfriends, someone she didn't know, to be her new maid of honor. Day before the wedding she asks me to be the usher, says I can show people to their seats, the gift table, the bathroom. I didn't attend the wedding. This last year I was my friend's best lady, which means I stood on the man's side. Everyone helped set the wedding up. It was a blast. I declared myself his shield maiden and spent the entire time protecting him from everything, even a few birds in a bush. This last year I was my friend's best lady, which means I stood on the man's side. Everyone helped set the wedding up. It was a blast. I declared myself his shield maiden and spent the entire time protecting him from everything, even a few birds in a bush. You and your friend sound like real brothers. Friend from college. We spent 3 months planning her bridal shower. She was not at all involved. When she finally looked at the plans 1 week before the party, she said it wasn't what she'd had in mind. She then delays the wedding, which every one of her 400 guests had already made travel accommodations for, so that she can have her dream bridal shower. Plans $25,000 weekend in Vegas. Booked presidential suite for herself and economy rooms for us, which she expected us to double up in. Wanted us to pay for the trip between us all evenly. 25,000/7=3,570 per person. And this isn't even including her. She said, "You're my bridesmaids. You're kind of supposed to pay for my bridal shower." I didn't have that kind of money at the time and told her so. Same with 5 other bridesmaids. The other 2 were her sisters. So she and her sisters have the bridal party on their own. Day of the wedding. She informs me I need to dye my hair and pay for it myself because my hair color is too similar to hers and it would be distracting. There aren't enough redheads, so I was thinking you could be a redhead. To top it all off, she informed us after the ceremony that to save money, we wouldn't be served a meal along with the rest of the guests. You already had the privilege of being in my wedding. So, what more can you ask for? I didn't contact her again after the wedding. She reached out to me to ask how to return my gift for store credit. I never replied. TLDR. Pay $3,750 each for my bridal shower. Dye your hair. And oh, by the way, I didn't get you food because you're not a normal guest. Can you let me know how to return your gift for store credit? I can put up with a lot of crap, but if you don't feed me at a wedding after all the crap, that's a walkout. Take my gift and leave their life forever kind of thing. Eating at the wedding you're part of the wedding party for is such a low bar, I wouldn't even consider it as part of my expectations. It's so obvious. I was in a wedding where the bride planned 2 separate bachelorette weekends for herself and got mad at anyone who wouldn't spend 2 3-day weekends at $500/each away from their husband's kids' jobs. The week leading up to the wedding, the temp for the big day was forecast to be a high of 10°F. February wedding. New US. Bride was insisting on outdoor photos without coats because we can't hide the dresses, everyone, including the photographer, tells her heck no. Day of, she pitches a fit when we refuse to do more than 1 quick photo. Afterwards, she stopped talking to 75% of the bridal party because of their refusal to accommodate her outrageous demands. To this day, years later, she still complains about how her bridesmaids ruined her wedding. Has wedding in February. Wants outside photos. There were a lot of moments. One of my favorites was her bachelorette party was the same weekend as my birthday. We weren't allowed to do anything for my birthday at all on the trip. Not even mention it. On my actual birthday, some of my friends got some balloons and a little cake from the hotel. They tried to keep it a secret, but Bridezilla came in the room, saw everything, didn't say a word and walked out. She was peeved because our friends wanted to do something small for me on my actual birthday. It was fitting that the wedding ended in huge family drama. I definitely stopped talking to her after the wedding was over. Dude, that sucks. I'm sorry. My birthday was 2 weekends before my best friend's wedding, but we live several hundred miles apart, so we didn't get to celebrate my birthday together. At her rehearsal dinner, she gave me a tiara, a birthday girl sash, and a gift and said she wanted her rehearsal dinner to also be a late birthday party for me. She's definitely a keeper. Not a bridesmaid, but a witness to one. The bride got walked out on by her entire bridal party, except her maid of honor. Of course, it was because no one loved her, and everyone wanted to ruin her day, not because she ripped a bridesmaid's dress from the neck down, in an open area, because it was too white. It was the dress the bride insisted on all the maids wearing. The bride got walked out on by her entire bridal party. Goddamn. Never seen a vote of no confidence at a wedding before. Loads of little things adding up. 2 things I remember standing out. She started with the turbo crazy at her hen do. It cost over £400 to spend a 3-day weekend away. That's not unreasonable in itself. But rather than appreciate the effort everyone made, she came back from night 2 screaming her head off that one of the girls was a miserable bee for coming back from a club an hour earlier than the rest of the hens because she wasn't feeling comfortable in the big crowd. She said she would make her pay, and then gloated on the eve of the wedding that she had put her on a table with a very attractive girl because she knew she was insecure about her looks and wanted her to feel self-conscious as punishment for the early date 3 months earlier, spoke to me like absolute crap the whole run up to the wedding, then pitched a fit at me in front of the whole bridal party because I had the nerve to bring a bag with my purse car keys in it after she had mandated we were all to leave our stuff at her house, with no way of picking it up as she and the groom were staying in a hotel that night. I was the only bridesmaid with no significant other to give that stuff to, so would have been stranded at the venue without it. Made me see how vile a person she is, and our friendship is now over following her pulling some even more crazy crap a few months later. Just a shame I wasted so much energy on her over the years. Picked $400 bridesmaid dresses. Destination bachelorette that cost over $1,200. Insisted on a super expensive spot for the bridal shower. Registered at Williams Sonoma. I was a broke but college student with limited funds, but managed to pay for all this crap and give a gift. Bonus points. Her husband forgot his entire freaking tux and didn't figure this out until a few hours before the ceremony. A few minutes before the ceremony, when she screamed at me for like the 500th time that day, I snapped and told her either she cut her crap or I was getting in my car and going home. She cut her crap. The rest of it went fine. Yes, I have an appreciation for what really broke is, and I was not that. Right on, bridesmaid. Rain in that bulls. Good job. She wouldn't let our friend who was on chemo to sit down after they all walked down the aisle. B for bride, F for friend. F had very aggressive breast cancer that she battled for 2 years. One of her doctors in Texas was charged with attempted murder for trying to poison a colleague, so she was going through a very hard time. Google Texas oncologist poisoning. B is a me type of person that has a controlling husband and doesn't do anything without him. Immediately after the wedding, B finds out her new mill also got breast cancer, but her prognosis was not bad at all. F was going to treatment in Texas, Boston, Chicago, etc. just to try to beat it. When she found out that the experimental treatments weren't working for her, she wanted her best friend, B, to provide some support. B told her to try to understand why she couldn't, because her mill also had BC. B cut contact, wouldn't call back, respond to texts, nothing. After we heard from F's husband that they no longer were in contact, we also cut contact with B and her new husband. Everything she did, or didn't do, was enough for us. We got a call one day from F's husband. The call made it seem as though F was ready to see people, but it would be in the hospital. We went there, super happy to finally see her. When we got there, we saw people we never met crying, and that's all it took for us to know it was F dying. We were there to send her off. I ended up with a nasty staph infection in my hand from the hospital. Her funeral was a week later. That was when I texted B a nasty message about what a crap friend she had been and that I hoped she was happy that she didn't get to say she was sorry or goodbye to her so-called best friend. Mind you, I had no F for about 3 years and rarely saw her. F was an oncology nurse. Go figure. She told her husband that I was one of the only ones that would reach out to her and ask her how she was doing when B wouldn't even reply to a text. B showed up to the viewing. I flipped her off and told her to stop acting. I actively hate her. Some people are such ignorant assholes. When I get married, it's going to be relaxed, good music, good alcohol and good friends. Sit when you like, FFS. What did that B do at your wedding? Soon-to-be mother-in-law doesn't show up to the wedding cause she hates her soon-to-be son-in-law. Reasons still unknown years later, but she dang sure showed up to the reception for the free food and open bar. Not my wedding, but my cousin's. Her best friend kept jumping into every picture she could, and she'd stick her middle finger up at the camera in every picture. And then she tried to make out with the groom. No one has heard from her since the wedding. My uncle went around taking photos and getting people's names and addresses to send them the photos. A month later, he sent out photos, printed on an advertisement for his fly-by-night prepaid legal business, along with hard sell marketing material. So basically, he lied about what he was doing to get people's contact info for his business. Pretty pee-off about that one. Ha ha ha, that's great. I mean, it's crappy, but it's great. Her jackass cousin tackled her, the bride, in her wedding dress. I approached him and asked something like, "Why did you do that? She's in her dress." He looked down, walked away to leave and muttered, "I was just freaking around." Mother-in-law left immediately following the ceremony. She loves to be over the top and dramatic. She didn't even say anything to my wife before doing so. We only found out when it was time to take pictures that she left, missed all the photos in the reception and never gave her a reason. She hasn't spoken to her daughter in over 2 years. Most likely blames everyone else for her problems rather than herself. It blows my mind. Not going to lie, probably better off without that type of person in your life. My sister's wedding was a bit over the top but beautiful. Castle, south of France. Need I say more? She had this group of friends who all put some money in an envelope as a present. One girl, the new girlfriend of one of the boys, said something like, "I don't have a lot to give and feel embarrassed to put my participation in front of you," so she took the envelope in the loo and added her money there, away from judging eyes. Yep, you guessed it. She took more than 500 euros from the envelope. They only find out when one of those friends asked, weeks later, if the newlyweds had enjoyed the 1,000 euro during the honeymoon. The girl's excuse was that she was planning her own wedding and could just afford a city hall affair and it was so unfair my sister had such a great venue. I'm personally quite immune to princess wedding day but stealing money at a wedding is so wrong. I think the girl ended up as a bit of a castaway. My sister's marriage didn't last anyway so I don't know what happened to her group of friends but I often think of this girl and imagine her as one of life's constantly unhappy and envious. No way. I hope they called the dang cops on her. My mother-in-law changed our reception venue behind my back. Luckily, I found out and was able to get it changed back. This was my first introduction to her boundary issues. I have since learned that if she thinks there is even the slightest chance that someone won't do what she wants, then she feels completely entitled to use whatever means necessary to get her way. I think she legitimately believes that people who won't do what she wants are purposely being mean to her. She also passed out dollar store glow necklaces at our reception. She didn't ask me or anything, of course. It was a complete surprise to see her handing out glow necklaces as wedding favors. Frick, that's my worst nightmare. Not a B, a C. Little guy Big Mouth was a really close friend until at my wedding he stood in front of my mum when we were cutting the cake and proceeded to give her the finger when she asked him to move over a little. Just after that while my dad was taking photos of me and my wife cutting the cake he keeps nudging my dad's arm so he would get a shaky photo. My dad gave him a swift elbow to say frickin' stop, then said C stamps on my dad's foot. My dad loses it, pushes him out of the door to my father-in-law, who then pushes him further outside to his brother who is a big guy and an ex-bouncer, picks him up by the collar and slaps him around the face a couple of times and drops him on the floor. Cops were called because he wouldn't calm down and had a night in the cells. I don't speak to him anymore. If you are reading this, Ricky, you are a C. The dad-dad-in-law combo pleases me. Family unity. Not my wedding. I was just hotel management. Bridesmaid got so drunk she crapped herself, then proceeded to walk crawl down the hallway to and from the public restroom and then the elevator dribbling crap down her leg. Then she passed out in front of the elevator and crap some more. Showed up, on H. She barely made it past the ceremony. My now wife's best friend did this. Not my wife. It still made for a huge crap show behind the scenes. She got stuck in the outhouse or something. She deliberately took forever to get ready and started a fight with her boyfriend, my husband's best friend and best man, right before the wedding. They showed up late because of the whole thing, which caused our whole wedding ceremony to be 20 minutes late. It is well known that she doesn't like me, so it was obviously a power play and done on purpose. She then didn't talk to me once during the entire wedding. It felt very awkward. I have one photo of me on the dance floor and she is in the background giving me the worst stink eye. LOL. The photo must be awesome. What a bee. Not mine but my friend's brother's rather religious wedding. Bride's mother makes a speech and says, "Deadpan, if you hurt her, I will slit your throat." In her speech, at the wedding where her daughter is marrying the nicest guy, everyone was so stunned and embarrassed. No one laughed. Bride and groom could barely look at her. My sister bridesmaid frowned through the whole ceremony, like a pronounced frown with the pouty bottom lip, like not subtle at all. Destroyed all the pictures from the ceremony. She then got drunk, dominated every conversation. Then when one of my friends tried to change the subject, she became irate and later tried to convince me that my best friends don't really like me and had begged her to go on a group date with them. Yup, until it was embarrassing. Of course, when I didn't believe this insanity, she immediately told me a completely outlandish story about being abducted by aliens and how if I don't believe her, I'm a C because she wrote about it in her journal once. So that means there's proof. I think it's official. She's lost her freaking mind. This reminded me of the fact that I ruined all of my sister's wedding photos because my resting face just macked me looked enraged. Couldn't smile either because I always looked like Chandler from Friends. Damn it, I had just repressed that. At my brother's wedding, his mother-in-law sat her 11 last-minute guests at our guests' table because she clearly did not give a frick about my family's guests. We couldn't add another table because we were at the max tables that would fit in the venue. So I had to ask the reception venue staff to add chairs to our other tables, which overcrowded our other tables and fricked up our seating chart. His mother-in-law cuts me off saying no, you cannot have 13 people to a table. It's unlucky. Then B, why did you steal our table? Ha, you freaking dumbass superstitious B. What the heck were we supposed to do? Ask our guests to leave? I completely ignored her, turned to the staff member, and had them add the chairs anyway. Okay, I'm done ranting. My uncle, he made a scene about how his doctor had misdiagnosed his mental illness. He doesn't have one. He's an attention W and claims he has every disease disorder under the sun. For years, how he was going to sue them, etc. He literally stood up and made a speech about it. We had a very small wedding, only be about 40 guests, so it was completely inappropriate. Ex-girlfriend who I hadn't spoken to in 4 years sent me a text message minutes before the ceremony was to start that simply said, "Don't." Totally threw me, and whilst I was able to brush it aside and get on with the job at hand, I've never really forgotten it. Also, my wife's only brother, who is an attention-seeking knob, came out to her and all her friends the night before the wedding. Even though everyone knew for decades he was gay, but chose to choose that night to take the attention away from his sister, who he was insanely jealous of. That would have been a perfect opportunity for a new phone. Who dis? My mother. My so and I ended up doing a courthouse type marriage. Did the papers. Found someone to marry us. Went to her office to do it. The only people there were my ex-stepdad. I call him bonus dad. Mom. Aunt. Uncle. And grandmother. My mom was my maid of honor. Bonus dad was my SOS best man. Right in the middle of our vows, my mom breaks down sobbing, interrupting everything. The B is obviously trying to get the attention on her since she can't seem to stand not being the middle of everything. We try to continue over her sobbing but only starts crying louder. My aunt, being the amazing person she is, grabbed the ring from my mom, pushed her towards my uncle, who pretty much dragged her outside. Aunt quickly announced she's the maid of honor now, which I was completely fine with, and the vows carried on. After signing everything, we go out to get to the car and my mom is just furious at me for letting your aunt do that. I just ignored her and went to the car. On the upside, when we were saying our vows, bonus dad started tearing up. It made me happy because it was super unlike him. Kinda guy who never says I love you, because that's just him. Ex-first sergeant. Served from 1972 to 2007, manly man. I love you, bonus dad. Frick you, mom. I'm amazed by how many moms carry on like this. It's nuts. I get angry just thinking about this. It was my husband's best friend's mom, who was not invited, but showed up anyway, and brought a bunch of small children with her. It was explicitly her no kids, no exceptions wedding. Tried to sit at the same table as me and tried to take pictures of me while I was eating, and loudly criticized one of the caterers because she thought she saw him put a used spoon into a buffet dish. He didn't. My mom, who is pretty blunt, straight up asked her, "Who are you and why are you here?" I personally addressed all the invitations and I know we didn't invite you. To which she replied, "Well, my son needed a ride." My mom told her to leave, which was so unbelievably awkward, but she left without making more of a scene. Your mom is the queen of badassery with a spine of titanium. got outrageously drunk, fought with their so, didn't spend time with any of the wedding party, created unnecessary drama with family members, never said congratulations. Yeah, my brother-in-law is a bee. At my mom's best friend's wedding, a young lady decided to wear a white floor-length dress and kept asking the DJ to play all these line dancing songs that only she knew the moves to. I think the groom was more pee than the bride, so part 2 of my wedding gift to them was to casually drag her off the dance floor and talk to the DJ about redding the room when it came to requests. So many of these stories involve butthole DJs that just don't get how to properly do their job at a wedding. Baffles my mind. Mother-in-law showed up 30 minutes late, told my wife she looked terrible, made negative comments the whole time. Been working on a nice jig to do over her grave ever since. Upvote for jig, I love jigs. After the ceremony, we were taking group pics with both families. After a couple of pictures, my mother-in-law starts walking around loudly proclaiming, "Can we get a picture with just the close family, please?" My husband and I were like, sure, but then she kept saying it over and over again, until finally I realized she wanted a pic without me in it but was just being passive-aggressive about it. So finally I'm like, "Do you want me to move?" And she's like, "Yeah, that would be great. I've been meaning to get some family pics done and this is the perfect location." Continues to get a million pics of her. She's my husband's stepmom, her kids and their families, and my husband and his brothers, while I'm just standing off to the side awkwardly. Then come Christmas, she has the audacity to send my parents a Christmas card using one of the pics of just them from the wedding with a little "from our family to yours" line. This on top of the million other things she's done to be awful. I cannot stand this woman. I would have later requested that the photographer delete all those photos, but I'm also super petty about that crap. If you're paying, you decide. She got super drunk, gave a speech during the ceremony where she was apparently channeling my dead mom, whom she had never even met, saying how proud my mom was of me. Then later, during the actual reserve time for speeches, she again, uninvited, shared the story of when I met my husband and how I actually wasn't interested in him BC I was trying to frick his friend at the time. She didn't say trying to frick, but she may as well have. It's totally true, but did she have to announce it to my entire group of wedding guests? What a nightmare. We are not friends anymore. Where she was apparently channeling my dead mom, I would be totally okay with this ending, and that's when I killed her. I'm not an actually violent person, but there are things you just don't do say. B stood around and loudly complained about our cake choice, the photographer, our music, and the flowers. B also didn't stop the music I had chose for the wedding march when I had instructed her to. B was the wedding planner. The day before my wedding, my husband's female roommate texted him saying she didn't think she could come to the wedding because she'd be in such emotional pain and would miss him so much. Instead, she said she'd be sitting at home, watching rom-coms, and eating Ben and Jerry's. I kid you not, she had liked him for 2 years. He had assumed she would respect reasonable boundaries like "I have a girlfriend and I'm not interested." Do not passive-aggressively confess to your crush the day before they get married. Skipped my bridal shower and bachelorette party, but found time to go, uninvited, to the strip club with my husband, his friends, and her boyfriend, who was a groomsman. Came to my wedding dressed as a H and congratulated me by saying she thought it would be her getting married first. We're obviously not friends anymore, and these aren't even the main reasons for that. Give her some credit, maybe she was not invited to the strip club but scheduled by the manager. Well, I don't want to call my mom a bee, but it fits the category. My wife and I told her she could wear any color dress she wanted except navy blue, as that was the bridal party color. What color dress does she wear? Navy blue. Also, I have a suspicion that my two cousins that were there that were not invited by me were invited by my mom. My mill did the same balls, except I said she could wear a little bit. She took that to mean floor-length gown in exact color and shade and claimed it wasn't the same really because it had some silver beading on top. I have a couple. Unfortunately, my first marriage didn't go very well. At the wedding, I had a rented tux on and I asked my new wife not to smear cake on me when we cut the cake because of that. Of course, when the time came, it wasn't just a cute smear of frosting or something like you'd see at most weddings. Oh no, She full-on plastered me with cake and a mess of frosting and food coloring. I don't know what was worse. Being angry and hurt and embarrassed when the whole room was watching, or when people were pulling me aside later and apologizing for it when her and her parents were still laughing and making jokes about it a couple of hours later. I thankfully remarried a great person years later, and we had a small ceremony that was really very nice. Our photographer was taking pictures afterward before we were heading to the reception, and I had been talking to my dad when he started, so he just took our picture together first. My mom, being who she is, was incensed by not being first to get her picture taken when she wanted and proceeded to throw a fit and leave. My parents had been divorced for at least a decade or so prior to this. Maybe a couple of minutes later, we were all lining up and getting family together for pictures, and when I couldn't find my mom, I learned that she'd stormed off and left. On what would otherwise be one of the best days of my life, there'll always be that storm cloud of pettiness that she left behind because she couldn't handle putting one of her kids ahead of herself for 10 minutes worth of time. And there, right there, is an illustration of exactly who I don't want to be. God help me, I hope I'm never like your mom. Showed up in a trashy version of my bridesmaid's dress and brought an uninvited guest. Jokes on her. Everyone knows she was a complete idiot to try and do that, and someone actually told her later that it was super crappy. Reminds me of my Bill's wedding. My sir was the best man and I happened to own a nice dress in the bride's favorite color, the color vest the groomsmen wore. I had to explain to my sir that it was not a good idea to wear it specifically because we'd match and I would look like a tacky clinger in every picture. I know a girl who wore white consistently to all of the weddings she was invited to one wedding season. She was also very aggressive at all of the bouquet tosses. So much secondhand cringe. Everyone was a bee. I had a destination wedding and paid for people to come. People only stayed about an hour at our reception and took off to do tourist stuff. My husband and I spent the majority of our reception alone. We paid out a lot of money to make sure people had fun and they all left. 10 years later and it still pisses me off. It was a small wedding and it did not sure prices now, cost that much to fly to this destination. It was on a beach at a resort. Whoa, that's really fricked up. A whole new level of inconsiderate and egotistical. I'm really sorry to hear they acted this way. I love my aunt, but she scrapped our planned DJ for a live band without telling us. Needless to say, a Skinhead cover band was not what I had in mind for my wedding. And I love me some Skinhead. We gave them a CD with our song on it. After a few minutes and then realizing they didn't have the equipment to play our song, they just started playing something random. I still have no freaking clue what song we shared our first dance as a married couple to. I'm a petty enough guy that if this happens at my wedding, I just won't dance until we can get the right song. I don't care if it's coming off YouTube on a phone stuffed in my pocket. We're dancing to our song. Bridesmaid. I had only a glimpse of her crazy prior to this. Frequent emotional meltdowns throughout the day, disappear to cry for a while, sucker another bridesmaid to comfort her, and carry on like nothing without identifying a source of discontent. Yelled at the nicest woman in the building, not even in wedding party, just being helpful, and stormed off swearing when her decorations weren't perfect, left saying I can't do this and drove away in a fit with flowers for the reception in her car, eventually showing up late, adding flowers to tables, acting like nothing happened. Bridesmaids were excellent buffers the whole time and it later came out she was jealous of me getting married to a man, and not her. Talk about a twist. Whoa. Wore the same color dress as the bridesmaids, even though she was expressly told not to, and her dress was real loose on the top so her tee kept falling out. Walked around taking pictures during the ceremony with a stupid little point and shoot camera. She's in the background of literally over half of our wedding pictures. It was almost 10 years ago, and I'm getting pee off all over again thinking about it. By the time of our wedding, my husband's 33-year-old sister was still single and she hated that her younger brother was getting married first. How did she deal with it? By trying to sabotage my wedding. The night before our wedding, she got s-faced and, while ugly crying, told my husband that it was supposed to be her wedding and it wasn't fair because she'd be able to plan a much better wedding than ours. That would eventually prove to be false, as she finally got her on again, off again boyfriend to propose by giving him an ultimatum. We had a small elegant outdoor wedding at a mountain lodge, and my sil convinced some family members on my husband's side that the dress code was casual, so they showed up in jeans, t-shirts, and hoodies. I was beyond upset with them for readily taking my sil's word without double checking with us. Luckily my photographer was sensible enough to exclude them from the pictures as much as possible. At our reception she went around complaining to our guests about how cheap our wedding was. My husband's side is used to those typical church and banquet hall weddings and ours was way different. But still, it's rude to crap all over someone else's wedding at their wedding. The lodge had a hot tub on the property, and near the end of the night when people were starting to leave, she changed into her bathing suit and chilled in the hot tub. This was planned ahead of time because she thought to bring her bathing suit there. My husband and I don't really talk to her anymore. Yikes. Also, what kind of idiot turns up to a wedding in a hoodie? Even if it's casual, surely you want to look good. People who work in the wedding marriage industry, what is the craziest drama you've experienced at a wedding? I wasn't working that weekend, thank the Lord, but bride asks for money only as wedding presents. During dancing, she sneaks over to the basket full of the envelopes and opens them up, counting her take. It's less than she hoped, so she calls the police, gets the DJ to stop the music, and accuses the waitstaff of stealing her gifts, lines up the guests, asks each one publicly how much they gave her, screams at the police when they arrive to do something, sues the restaurant, or at least was threatening to when I stopped working there. That's so insane. When I get a card with money and a check in it, I always try to pretend that I'm not trying to see how much it is and that I'm just really into the card. I can't imagine doing something like that. I attended a wedding where a coked out bride fired the DJ 30 minutes into the reception and just played her iPod the rest of the night. It was a huge fancy wedding, not a backyard thing. I don't work in the industry, but attended a wedding where this happened. My co-worker was having her wedding on a public beach in Southern California. They weren't able to reserve anything, just make do with it the best that they could. Well, right before she was due to walk down the aisle, a homeless man stumbles into the group of people guests and passes out midway into the aisle. A couple of guys go over to get him to move, but the dude wasn't waking up. Ended up giving him CPR for a solid 20 minutes while waiting for the ambulance. Didn't hear anything else about him after they carried him off the beach. That's like the worst omen ever. I'm a wedding officiant. The worst I saw was the venue manager punch the DJ square in the face, splattering blood all over the bride's dress. The venue manager was drunk and didn't like that particular song the DJ was playing. The bride thankfully laughed it off as the groomsmen carried the kicking and screaming venue manager to the door and literally threw him on his ass out the door of his own venue. The venue owner was then called and came to take the manager home. The venue owner gave them 50% off the rental cost on the spot. The bride and groom couldn't have been happier. Was the manager a wedding guest because you don't effing drink at work? Wedding DJ here. Bride was looking for groom to do the first dance. Took them about 30-40 minutes to track him down. He was barfing in the bathroom. When he came back into the hall, he smelled strongly of weed and had clearly been drinking heavily. They finally got him out of the bathroom. We start the first dance and he's clearly in bad shape. Bride starts lecturing him throughout their first dance. True love. I worked at a wedding reception for 4 years and boy do I have a lot of stories. However, I'll try to condense it down. 1. Probably the one that was the most fricked up. Bride and groom are middle-aged with a few kids already, one being an 8-year-old boy. Towards the end of the night, we witness the groom and the father of the children beating the crap out of a guest. After breaking up the fight, we learned that this guest had attempted to molest the young boy, son of the groom, in the bathroom. It was the worst thing we have ever experienced there, and I felt terrible for the kid and the parents. We had to hide the man because the guest literally wanted to hurt him, but regardless of what we thought, we couldn't let that happen. So the guy's in our office area where I'm working and he is with the woman he came there with, and judging from the nature of their conversation, I gathered that this was not the first time he had acted inappropriately towards a kid, and she seemed to just accept it. I was seething and it ended up going to court. We gave statements. 2. We had a wedding cancelled a few days before due to cheating. They still hope to get a refund. 3. The obvious pants splitting. The groom needed an emergency set of pants after splitting them just before the ceremony. 4. A lot of fights have happened. People getting drunk and angry is too common. From what we gathered, there was animosity between two halves of the groom's family, and it ended with a huge fight between brothers and uncles in the car park. 5. Someone's grandma had a heart attack mid-reception and had to be taken to hospital. Worked as a server at a place that did occasional wedding receptions. At one event, the staff was asked to see if anyone knew where the bride was, as no one knew where she had gotten off to and hadn't been seen recently. She was quickly found, in a bathroom stall, completely passed out, still holding a bottle of wine. Occasional wedding DJ here. Nothing too wild so far, but at one wedding I worked this summer, everyone was super cool except the maid of honor, who sucked. I arrived to set up and she was alone in the little DJ alcove, shoes off, reading a book, while everyone else was enjoying cocktails below. Okay, maybe she just needed a break. I tried making polite chit chat and asked her about the ceremony. She kind of made a face and said it was weird that her best friend was married. Every other topic I tried had similar results. Every glass was half empty for this girl. Dance time rolls around and I'm playing the music the bride and groom requested, but maid of honor doesn't like it. Keeps coming up and yelling in my ear that no one is dancing, everyone hates the music, etc. Not true. They weren't a super dancey crowd, but there was never an empty floor and the bride and groom were having fun. I always have a pen and paper handy so people can write down their requests. Ma writes down a list of 7 or 8 songs to be played in that order. Wildly different songs from what the clients requested, BTW. Think hard rap and club bangers that would absolutely horrify the older guests, when the clients mostly wanted stuff like Group Love. Comes back up to yell at me and demand I play her songs 1 or 2 more times. I tell her I'm getting there. Finally comes to a head when I start playing a Donna Summer song that a very polite and sweet young groomsman requested. He and his friends are dancing away having a grand time. Maid of honor storms into my alcove, gets in my face, and goes, "What is this? I thought I told you to do this," pointing to her dumb playlist. "I wish I could tell you I headbutted her or something, but I just told her I was going to stick with the bride and groom's requests and she finally fricked off." The bride was so sweet and chill. No idea how the two of them were best friends. Oh, sweet, sweet jealousy. Don't work in the wedding marriage industry, but my husband's best friend's wedding was a crap show. The groom ended up getting so drunk he passed out on the dance floor during the reception and had to be taken to the hospital to get his stomach pumped. The wedding actually happened a few months after the bride was caught cheating. She ended up getting pregnant by the guy she was cheating with twice after the wedding. And no, they never got a divorce. The groom is taking care of 3 kids that aren't his. Not drama, but definitely off-putting. At one wedding, the maid of honor made a 25-minute long speech full of cheesy platitudes, including a 10-minute foray into penguin love. Just awful. If you consider that they only had the venue for 5 hours, a full 10% of the time was spent on this god-awful speech. I witnessed a fight between the groom and an ex-boyfriend moments before the bride arrived. They said their vows and got married all whilst the groom's right eye started to swell up. The cake was delicious though. I worked in event planning for about 10 years, and it was almost entirely weddings. The most dramatic would probably be the time the groom discovered he was allergic to horses as he was being pulled down to the gazebo by several horses. We had to call an ambulance. He was okay after they got him some antihistamines, and his face was so swollen they couldn't take any pictures. Nice people. They were shockingly calm about the entire ordeal. I have so many stories. If anyone has questions or would like a specific type of drama, let me know. I used to work at a wedding venue as a dishwasher. Once the father of the bride refused to pay, and on the night of the wedding he looked at my boss and told her he wasn't paying for crap. He said things were wrong and not the way they were supposed to be, but everything was done to his specification. Without skipping a beat, my boss turned around and started telling everyone to go home. He quickly changed his tune and paid. Bride and her mother did a cake testing. We design a wedding cake for bride. All details are decided. Bride leaves happy. Mother of bride comes back alone to change design of wedding cake because the mother did not like the design the bride picked out. We told her, "Sorry, your name is not on the order to make any changes." Mother of bride walks out and slams the door. The Mennonites are my favorite people to rent out the church to. They always leave the church better than it was before they came. Yeah, we have let a Jehovah's Witness family use our barn for a wedding and it was the same. Never been so tidy. I sing in a wedding band and we always get requests for the first dances. The most unusual one was a mother-son dance, groom and mom. The song requested was The Lady Is a Tramp. This could be something from Arrested Development. I'm not in the industry, but when I got married there was another couple that was married the same day at the resort. The bride got into a fight with her future mother-in-law the night before. Physical fight, and a physical fight with her husband the day of the wedding. She looked miserable right after the wedding and all her guests stayed in their rooms with their custom do not disturb signs on their doors the entire stay. When we met other people at the resort and told them when we got married they had shocked looks. We had to say we're the couple that got married and don't get into domestic violence issues. Professional singer here. I was asked to sing at the wedding of an old friend about 10 years ago. The ceremony, rehearsal and subsequent dinner was great fun and I had a good time meeting all the fun people in this huge, elaborate wedding party. A cute groomsman caught my eye and, after getting super drunk at the rehearsal dinner, we stumbled back to my apartment that was a few blocks from the restaurant and hooked up. He was totally hot and very fun, and we had great chemistry, considering we had never met before. He didn't stay the night, which was fine by me, and we didn't exchange numbers or anything. That morning, as we were all getting ready for the ceremony to start, he took me aside and said, "So, you're gonna be cool, right? Because my fiance is here." I was horrified, not wanting to ruin my friend's wedding ceremony with a spectacular drama fest. I kept quiet until the reception, where I got super drunk and, thereby, lost all my decorum. I'm 6 years sober last month. I hand wrote a note on the back of a program and gave it to the fiance before I wobbled back home. I later heard there was crying, screaming, and punching. PSH. I would have done the same thing. Good for you for letting her know and congrats on your sobriety. I'm a wedding photographer, and at one wedding, the bride went to put on her dress and it didn't fit. It was a corset back with the flap that pulls across under it, but she had gained weight and the flap didn't go all the way across her back anymore. Full stop. Her mom started hysterically yelling at her daughter saying she warned her she was getting fat and should have stopped eating so much. The bride is in tears and mortified. I had to kick the mom out of the room and take control of the situation. Luckily the hotel sheets were a close enough ivory, so we cut a piece from the sheets to use as the fabric under the corset threading and it was passable. I kept the mom away from the poor bride all day. Above and beyond the call of duty, on behalf of married people everywhere, thank you. The caterer got drunk at the reception. This was before food service and at least partly on the alcohol purchased by the wedding party. He may have had some beer in one of his coolers too. The food was at least an hour late and not good. Supposedly the people he had coming to help serve bailed on him so his girlfriend came to help. She was wearing a dress that barely covered her cheeks and he was enjoying being able to get very handsy with her. Yes, those were the same hands prepping the food. He got very drunk after food was served and took the mic from the DJ and proceeded to propose to his girlfriend at someone else's wedding when he was supposed to be working. Someone from the crowd shouted out, "But I saw you with another girl Thursday." He left the sink full of dirty dishes, an inch deep puddle of chicken juice in the fridge, coolers of food outside, and had to leave his truck trailer because he couldn't drive home. He then denied leaving the mess despite the photos of it. We don't have a preferred vendor list, but we have a list of one vendor who isn't welcome back. This sounds like the plot to a half-decent sitcom episode. I used to help out at my church with weddings and I had the cutest drama ever. Two little boys were ring bearers and it was time for them to walk down the aisle and the littler one, probably 3 years old, just stood there. His older brother, probably 5 years old, nudged him to go and the little one turned around and pushed him back. So the older one pushed him and they fought and wrestled and pushed each other the whole way down the aisle. I found that hilarious. I am not so sure the bride did though. Never work with kids and animals. W.C. Fields. Three of the bridesmaids got absolutely sloshed during the wedding reception and let it slip that they had a foursome with the groom at his bachelor party the week before. The mother of the bride found out and told the rest of the parent table as well as the entire bridal party. Needless to say, it was a pretty tense dinner service. The bride told staff there would be an annulment the next day. An unfortunate way of spending 60k in one evening. Worked in the industry for the last 6 years at a resort. This doesn't even scratch the surface of things I've had to deal with, lol. I need more. This crap is like crack to me. Wedding planners, what made you say this one's not even going to last a year? I have seen brides fight their grooms at the reception. I've seen a bride bash a family member over the head with a bottle of champagne. I've seen small children whip burning tea lights at guests from a floor above. I've seen a guest try to fake a slip and fall to sue the venue. Probably the most WTF was a very obviously arranged marriage. Most of the planning was done by the parents, because they were local and the kids were traveling overseas. Red flag. Day of, we meet the happy couple-to-be. I'm really bad at judging ages, but she seemed at least old enough to consent. And, I should add, she was gorgeous. Could have been a model. The groom, however, almost a foot shorter than she, very lanky, looked like he was squarely in the middle of an adolescent awkward phase. My staff and I had difficulty not giving any outward signs that we were very uncomfortable. The body language was perplexing and then just sad during photos. Culturally, it's not uncommon for PDA to be kept to a minimum, but the way she leaned away from him and could barely look at him, she was so obviously miserable. To this day I regret not offering to help her escape through a bathroom window. I told myself it was not my place to interfere in that I should just shut up and do my job. I will never take another client without a face-to-face with the bride first. I hope they're not still together. Event manager with a caterer. Pregnant maid of honor told the bride sister that she's been fricking the groom and the baby is his. She was dead sober, which is what made it so odd that it came out like that. Needless to say, we got to go home early that night. If she were pregnant, I would hope that she was sober. For the kid's sake at least. Oh man. The poor bride was 6 months pregnant at the time of the wedding. Puking regularly. The groom was 3 hours late to the ceremony. By hour two, he hadn't even picked up his tux. The venue almost cancelled the reception because the groom's number was the only contact they had and nobody knew what was going on. He finally showed up and everything went as planned, albeit 3 hours later. Years ago, I was a waitress at a fancy restaurant where we regularly had weddings. One night we had this massive wedding party. His side were one of those families with loads of money but not an ounce of class. Just rowdy, loud and incredibly rude, making sure to let everyone know how rich they were. She was a quiet, shy girl with a small family full of boring mousy types. As the night progressed, his family just got drunker and louder as hers hid in the corners, visibly annoyed. At one stage the groom grabbed the microphone and did a heavily intoxicated version of Frank Sinatra's My Way whilst his whole family cheered him on. Afterwards he turned to his bride and slurred over the speakers, "Tonight, we will do it my way, wifey," and then proceeded to make doggy style thrusting gestures. The bride flushed bright red, got up and walked out, her mum on her heels. She didn't come back. The groom stayed and got so trashed his disgusting family had to carry him out at the end of the night. It was spectacular. They didn't last long. If someone were writing a novel, and they had the drunk rich butthole husband stand up and sing My Way, I would throw the whole thing in the trash without reading another word because it would be so unbelievable. My sill. She announced in front of everyone how her wedding was blessed by God and mine wasn't because she was married in the Catholic Church and I had a civil ceremony. 7 years later and I'm the only one still married. Whoa, I can't help but think people who are rude like this in front of a large group make themselves look dumb as opposed to the person they are trying to embarrass. I had a wedding couple come to see me by appointment to plan the music for their church wedding ceremony. They each brought their respective mothers to the planning session. Right out of the gate, they started arguing over choices for the processional. The groom-to-be wanted something to show off the full organ, whereas the bride-to-be wanted something smaller scaled and gentle. There was no middle ground, no matter what organ pieces I showed them. Then, of course, their mothers took sides and further intensified their bickering, even though I asked them politely to let the couple choose their own selections. In the end, It really wasn't about the choice of music. It was about a fundamental crack in the foundation of their soon-to-be marriage, an unwillingness to compromise or to even hear what the other was attempting to convey. Sadly, their marriage ended in divorce in less than 2 years. How they made it that long, I'll never know. I catered weddings for several years, and the subtle sign I always paid attention to was how closely the bride and groom sat next to each other during the speeches, dinner, etc. The happy couples were always right on top of each other, sharing food, laughing, and just generally chatting. They were in their own world, while the rest of the wedding went on around them. Other times, the two would be practically on the other side of the table from one another. The groom would spend the whole meal turned away chatting with his groomsmen, while the bride looked the other way staring into space. Families can be buttholes, people get drunk, and nightmares happen, especially as the night progresses. But if you don't care enough to appreciate the presence of your spouse the very first time you sit down next to them, you have no chance once the real world takes over. This is very insightful. Thank you. Minister friend did a wedding once where in the vows the woman wouldn't say for richer or poorer, just kept saying for richer or richer, and she wasn't joking. They didn't last long. I used to play bass in a soul band that occasionally played weddings, so I'm not really in the planning business, but I was privy to some shitstorm weddings. The one that sticks out the most wasn't actually a wedding at all. One Saturday afternoon, the keys player and I drive up to a rural Texas town for what we assumed was just another wedding. We arrive at a fairly large church and are told to load in our gear into the gym. First thing I noticed that was off is the wedding was Dia de los Muertos themed. It was February. There was a plastic skeleton band at the entrance to the gym. I might still have a picture of it somewhere. We head over to a makeshift stage against the back wall and start setting up. The bride comes up to talk to us and she has fake blood all over her dress to go with the theme. She's in her mid-40s and clearly a huge fan of the band because I recognized her from a few previous shows. She already seemed a little drunk. So we set up, sound check, and we're told to leave the area for the ceremony and we will have our performance and dinner right afterward. So we hang outside the gym shooting the crap for about half an hour before we're told to come back in and play our set. We're all holding our instruments ready to go when the bride steps on stage and takes the mic from the lead singer. She says she's sorry the groom couldn't make it to the wedding. Then goes on a long-winded rant about how she doesn't think she'll actually ever get married, and how thankful she is that her dad was still willing to pay for her to have a wedding anyway. So long story short, this woman duped a bunch of people to a fake wedding that her dad paid for. I was sitting there with my mouth open the whole time thinking, what the frick is going on? I really wanted to know what happened for the 30 minutes we were sitting outside in the parking lot, but I never got a straight answer. We played the show, people seemed to have an alright time, ate some food, made some cash. But I never forgot the time I played a fake wedding. Dia de los Muertos themed, and Commerce Soul Band. I love it. Was a groomsman in a friend's wedding about 8 years ago. He was in the army and had a chaplain he was friends with officiate it. So we are all standing there listening, trying to act like we are paying attention. The chaplain is going on about couples today sometimes get married for the wrong reason. They don't know each other well enough, don't think things through, or rush into something they aren't ready for. So then he's silent for a moment and they start the vows. We were all in shock. The parents on both sides were furious. They lasted about 8 months. He was a reservist and got deployed out, was a cop when home, and she started sleeping with his patrol partner. Like 2 days after he left, he got an email from her saying it was over. She wasn't happy that she hated his husky and had tied her up and left the house a week ago. We all rushed over there as soon as he let some of us know. She was half starved but okay after some food, water and a rush to the vet. Man, frick around all you want, but leave the dog be, you she devil. My brother's wedding. Let's just say my brother is the epitome of brothers. I swear he was born wearing a polo shirt and Oakleys. His entire wedding weekend was more about him having to leave his drinking buddies and marrying his wife. The dinner the day before the wedding was at his favorite bar, which happens to be right across the street from his condo. His poor wife didn't get a word in about anything while the dinner and the reception speeches were just hordes of bros telling drinking stories. One of the bridesmaids tried to say something about the bride and actually got told to shut up by one of the groomsmen. The best man just happened to be my white supremacist uncle who had his Iron Eagle tattoo prominently shown throughout the ceremony. Half of the wedding pictures were my brother and his groomsmen showing off their alcohol-themed socks. Fun time though, a donkey started braying during the ceremony for about 5 minutes and I had the pleasure of hearing my drunken grandma loudly pronounce that this is a crap show. Me and my brother don't get along that well. My drunken grandma loudly pronounced that this is a crap show. I love your grandma. Also your brother's poor wife, are they still together? Bride warned groom several dozen times, in my presence, if he smashed the cake in her face they would have issues. Using phrases like I am not kidding or I am completely serious. Groom was a good old boy type. His friends found out about his bride's one stipulation about the wedding. She was flexible on a lot of other things, but no freaking cake smashing. They started making whip cracking sounds, teasing him that he was whipped and needed to put his foot down and show her who's boss. Yeah, he smashed the cake in her face. She had it annulled. They started making whip cracking sounds, teasing him that he was whipped and needed to put his foot down and show her who's boss. The fact that they think a guy is whipped and he needs to show her who's boss because she makes one rule about something she's uncomfortable with just shows what incredible buttholes they are. Not a planner, but a photographer. Bride and groom both lovely people, but the groom's mother. At the reception she got so drunk that she leaned over in her chair and just puked on the floor. She spent the next 2 hours wailing and crying because she told everybody thought her son deserved better. As I was packing equipment back into my car, I spotted Mill in the bushes, dress around her head, legs in the air and a group of people trying to get her out. I later found out that she crapped herself at a later point in the evening, and the bride spent time cleaning her up. Didn't think the marriage would survive with a toxic Mill like that around. Then I saw on social media that the bride and groom moved overseas, far away from their families. I love a happy ending. Obligatory not a wedding planner. I worked as a receptionist for a conservatory and garden. We were an extremely popular wedding venue 7 days a week year round. But this is the one that stuck out. A couple of families came in on a Sunday afternoon during business hours. They were dressed very nicely, but again, was a Sunday, so not all that unusual. There appeared to be an older teen girl, a boy around the same age, their respective parents, and a smattering of grandparents. Looking back on it, with the exception of a couple of the grandmas, everyone looked either ill or angry. Everyone but one of the fathers paid their admission and went inside. The father made it known to me he was still waiting for someone. No big deal. Well, about 10-15 minutes later, in came a priest. Black robes, white collar, the works. It then occurs to me that all these people must be here to scope it out as a wedding venue. I took the admission. Then went to get our on-site wedding coordinator, in case the family wanted to see her. I find her, and we start heading towards where I last saw the group. We were floored to see them by our water feature very obviously conducting a wedding. Very obviously a shotgun wedding that the kids had no control over. Was startling and funny and sad all at once. With the amount of strong-arming they got, I doubt they lasted. Please tell me your advisor butted in and kicked them out. I can't believe they would just show up and conduct a wedding out of the blue, especially at a place that charges for that. Wedding photographer here. Two things come to mind. In one instance, the bride and groom just could not be bothered to be seen together at the wedding. I had to virtually drag them for getting some photos of the two of them together and they kept walking off hang out with their friends. It would be one thing if they hadn't seen their friends in forever, but one friend they lived with and the others were in the same town. The other one was a groom who looked like he was 16. He was actually 21 but was tiny and looked young. When I started taking photos he said, in all seriousness, you have to tell me what I need to do. This is my first time getting married, I'll do better next time. Turns out the wedding only happened because the bride's mother was dying and the bride wanted her mother to see her get married. am wedding planner as well as officiant. I forgot to ask for and sign this couple's marriage license. I sign and send to the county for recording. So I texted the bride and she said, oh, no need, we haven't gotten our license yet and we'll do it legally a different day. Ok, a few months later she's with husband, not husband's BFF, and now they're engaged. I wonder if she'll be a repeat customer of mine. Repeat customers should get a voucher for free ice cream or something. Another not a wedding planner, but story. The night before our wedding, my husband and I were staying at the hotel we would be getting married at the next day. Another couple had gotten married there that night and our room happened to be right next to theirs. The couple had decided to continue the party in their room, blasting music, screaming at their friends from the balcony, and generally making so much noise at such a late time that we called the front desk. The next night, our own wedding was done. We were hanging out in our room, gorging on leftover cupcakes, and getting ready to go to bed. The couple next to us, it turns out, had decided to stay an extra night, but this time they were screaming at each other. We couldn't figure out what exactly was going on, but we clearly heard the woman yell, "I can't talk to you when you have your pouty face." 3 years later we still use that on each other and it instantly diffuses any argument. I often wonder what happened to them. I know a guy from college who broke his fiance's diamond engagement ring against a wall in a drunken rage while they were engaged. They still got married, but it has not been a year yet. We're convinced it won't last the year. Well, I'm the best man in an upcoming wedding, so I'm definitely involved in some of the planning. Just found out yesterday that it's already a sexless, affectionless relationship, so I give it a year tops. My poor bastard of a best friend thinks getting married will make it better. I think he is in for a surprise. It all makes me very sad. I'm a baker, not a wedding planner, but I deal with them and weddings constantly. Once was doing setup in a venue for this monster cake for 500 guests and a dessert table, usually with something that big and expensive. I'll stick around and ask the couple or the planner for approval before I leave. I finish and ask for the WP's approval and she comes in, sweaty and frizzled, and tells me it's okay, and I explain how to cut the thing, because it was so big if you didn't do it right it would topple. I ask her what is wrong, because she's out of it, not paying attention. She explains that the bride's boyfriend showed up to the reception space to get into the bridal suite, with the groom's boyfriend in tow. It was a shit show and people were going crazy fighting in the bridal suite. She thought it was going to come to fisticuffs. I came back to pick up the setup pieces for the dessert table the next day. Somehow they went through with the wedding, but that wasn't going to last. Not a wedding planner. But tomorrow a friend's 18-year-old sister is getting married to a 33-year-old man with two kids after being engaged for 3 weeks. I have a very bad feeling about the marriage. Hope I'm wrong and it lasts, but the whole thing gives me a creepy vibe. So he basically is marrying a babysitter. My mother plays harp for weddings in Colorado. My grandparents have lived off and on near Rocky Mountain National Park for the last 25 years, so we are very familiar with the finicky weather around one of Colorado's most spectacular wedding destinations. 10 years ago my mother planned her own wedding a stone's throw from the park. She knows the area is what I'm saying. If she says it might snow in April, it might snow in April. Why some people hire locals for their wedding and then refuse to listen to them is beyond me. Yes, it is cheaper than June. There's a reason for that. Wedding pro tip: if your wedding needs to be outside in Rocky Mountain National Park, schedule an indoor venue as a backup, and be ready to use it. YMCA of the Rockies is always good and you will still have your pretty butt mountains to look at. After one too many, bride, planner, or parent has stamped their feet upon having to bend one iota to the weather in a place that has a lot of it, she now has a weather clause written into her contract. She has spent 5 snowy April weddings with her harp tucked warm and safe inside her car, watching guests shiver miserably as they contemplate hiking up to the altar or church on top of a hill or whatever little blizzarding paradise they've stuck with. 5 people who refused to compromise on their vision for their special day to the point that they're standing on a hill in a snowstorm. Miserable. Surrounded by all the miserable people who know them. Imagine seeing your bride or your groom force everyone to sit in a goddamned blizzard in formal wear and throw a tantrum about something totally uncontrollable but also totally preventable. Mom has no problem cashing their checks at all. I imagine she doesn't get hired for their second and third weddings, but there's no shortage of clients anyway. This is actually my own story. The night before our wedding, my husband-to-be and I were out celebrating. We had a few drinks and then went out for dinner afterwards. As we were leaving the restaurant, we noticed a slab of cement that was just freshly poured. He bent down to carve our initials in the wet cement. As a romantic gesture, he carved his first, which were A, and then as he went to carve mine, he asked, "Should I carve KM or KH?" Well, KM isn't my initials but those of his ex, Kelly. I dated a Kelly once. Total freaking C. I'm not a wedding planner, though I was a wedding guest. The bride had a father who was mortgaging his home to pay for the wedding. She had been given everything as a child and became accustomed to life on a silver platter. She worked for Christian Dior in makeup sales and therefore insisted everything must be designer. She had a destination wedding that lasted a month at a villa in Italy. More than 50 people flew out and she had designer dresses and accessory for every single planned event for an entire month. There were non-stop events planned. She was the star of everything. Her husband was an afterthought and only beckoned for pictures when her personal photographer reminded her that they should take some together. The extravagance of the wedding put my estimate at 2 years tops. They made it about 2 years, pregnancy likely playing a big part in the longevity of the 2-year marriage. The father of the bride ended up living in the spare room of her condo with her and her new husband because the fathers of the bride had a wife that was not the bride's mother and the cost of the wedding was so outrageous that they divorced over it. Father of the bride was a sales rep for a medical company, not a millionaire. Bride gives no fricks because everything is about her and what she wants regardless of who it harms or affects. Rule of thumb, the more extravagant the wedding, the more likely they are compensating for a hollow relationship. Holy heck, you know your wedding is a disaster when it ruins someone else's marriage. Not wedding planner, but cook. Worked at a golf resort. We had open, green areas, lots of mid-fancy seating, various venues, etc. I used to run most of the banquets for my chef. He'd hand me planning sheets, I'd do the order, if he hadn't already, prep and cook everything day of, and have it out, hot, and ready to eat. He handed me a single sheet, telling me it was a 50-person buffet, with a grin on his face. I knew that grin. Looked over the menu. It was garbage. Steamed broccoli, the absolute bottom of the barrel cheapest ham product from Sysco, rolls and butter, large salads with only 3 dressing choices, mashed potatoes, but nothing else on the food docket. I asked if he was serious. He was. Told me they were total cheapskates and really were jerks. If they want dirt cheap, they'll get dirt cheap. Venue is the horrid awning next to the cart park. Basically a concrete slab with a grassy area next to it and an awning where the golf carts usually went. Facilities would move the carts. And that's where I'd set up. Front house would have 2 buffet lines for me. Talk to bartender. No bartender. But they were getting some horrid pee beer. And only 2 6-packs of it, and some horrid champagne ripoff that was $3 bottle. 3 bottles of it. Yep. Day of, I am out there in my chef coat getting my tables set up as I want them. Front house always mucks this stuff up. People start arriving, so I rush back, finish the last item, the broccoli, in the steamer, and into the hot box with it. I wheel out, am set up in 5 minutes. I've got to back up pre-cut ham and juice, a backup mashed taters, a backup salad, and a backup broccoli. The weak sauce alcohol selection is out with plastic champagne flutes. Front house is guarding it. I wondered why. Then I realized bride and groom were maybe 18. Maybe. The two fathers were drinking pee beer, doing their best not to look at each other. The groom was pee himself in a rented tux. The bride and bridesmaids were gossiping like teen girls do, paying him very little mind. The mothers of the newlyweds were staring daggers at each other from across the concrete slab. I looked a touch closer at the blushing bride and, yep, just barely showing a baby bump. This was a shotgun wedding due to unprotected teen sex I was catering. The guests barely touched the food, though they did eat all the salad and all the ranch dressing. The unused ham went back to the kitchen, never out on buffet, and then into ham and bean soup later. cream of broccoli for the unused broccoli, etc. I don't even give that a year. After reading these stories, I feel like there needs to be a follow-up as credit thread about people who have been in or witnessed shotgun weddings and what became of them, but my inbox is battered and abused. We had friends taking bets at our wedding on how long we were going to last. Most of them confessed they bet 6 months. I couldn't really blame them. We were together less than a year, just turned 18 and both going into the military. Worked out though. Celebrating 11 years next month. If only we got all those bets in writing, we'd be rich. Getting married young and for no apparent reason is a major military tradition. Did it. Divorced him, but we're on decent terms and he likes my new husband and I like his new wife, so a lot better than most military divorces. Met a few weeks earlier. Groom's friends were taking bets on how long the marriage would last. Both of them HS dropouts. From white trash families. Bride wore a black dress. My parents have been married now for 51 years. I do wedding photography. Can I play? I second shot at a very large, extravagant wedding. The wedding party were all sorority sisters and fraternity brothers at rival schools. There were 24 of them, 12 bridesmaids, 12 groomsmen. The couple's family had clearly spent a lot of money, especially on the decorations. Also, Ben Stein was there for some reason. The first thing the father of the bride said to me was a complaint about the groom. The groom didn't like the way the suits turned out, and insisted that all of the men return to the shop that morning to get something else. Those poor men's wear shop employees. I met the groom when it was time to do groomsmen photos, which I generally handled solo while the main photographer did bridesmaid photos. We typically do some posed shots and some informal ones. Well, the groom flat out refused to do any posed photos. I can usually convince reluctant subjects to just do the thing, but he absolutely would not do a single group photo. I seem to remember I finally managed to get some informal photos, like I was their paparazzi or something. But that was all he'd allow. As we were walking back to the main reception area, he told me he didn't even want to get married. This is all her thing. My photos weren't very good. I was working for this butthole studio manager, and I figured I'd get in trouble later and possibly wouldn't be hired again, but there wasn't much I could do. Photogs were responsible for specific coverage and types of images, to the point that we were on the hook financially. I was worried the couple would complain later about the lack of groomsmen photos. As it turns out, nobody ever said anything about it, and I was stressing over nothing. I have to imagine the studio owner knew about the groomzilla after planning coverage with them. I sometimes think about that couple. I hope they're not together anymore. The bride was really sweet, if not even a little superficial. She put a lot of work into that wedding. I hope she found someone who deserved it. My brother just got married a week ago. Everyone kept telling him the week leading up to the wedding that it's not too late to back out, even her family. I think that's a pretty good sign. What is the worst thing you've ever seen happen at a wedding? Divorced father of the groom started up about how much better his new wife was compared to his old wife, during his speech, on and the qualities of Asian women versus white women. I've never looked at my shoes so hard in my life. The sister of the bride who wasn't invited showed up drunk and got in a fight with the bride until the father of the bride broke it up by putting the sister in a chokehold and dragging her out of the venue. The bride was surprisingly fine afterwards. Source: I'm a wedding caterer. I was at a wedding where the best man got up and explained how important this speech was to him, because even though he has a stutter and public speaking is very hard for him, the groom had picked him. It immediately became clear that his stutter was severe, but everyone of course looked at each other like, isn't this amazing? What a touching moment. It felt like a movie moment as he struggled forward into what we all assumed would be a poignant speech. However, it quickly became clear that this was indeed one of the worst best man speeches of all time, with him referencing exes, freaking stories, jokes about the groom's small dong, and how hot he thought the bride was. But of course, it was all coming out in a slow, horrible stutter that made everything much, much worse. At the end, everyone was mortified except for him. He looked incredibly proud. This is freaking hilarious. Not for those present, but god dang. One of my wife's co-workers got married this past summer. Her father passed away from a fatal heart attack the morning of the wedding, but her family insisted and convinced her to go in with it, so she did. It was awkward as heck and nobody in the building made it through without crying, even the minister. My granddad did that the day before my wedding. Great way to go, all his kids there and a nice meal. My mother-in-law handed out an EP of my now sister-in-law to as many guests as she could and threw a fit in the middle of the dance floor later that night because I didn't let her daughter sing with the band or karaoke. Her exact words were, "How dare you make today all about you? It was my wedding day." I worked weddings for a living and once saw the best man get loaded, give a speech, and profess his love of the bride and how they had slept together two nights before. Open bar. 1. Best man. 0. That open bar did the groom a favor. Just prior to my sister's wedding ceremony beginning, as everyone was getting in place and last minute things were being done in this big old Catholic church, my father noticed a woman with a confused look at the back of the church and approached her, asking if she needed anything. She informed him she was the bride, then opened a beat-up suitcase she had which contained something resembling a wedding-type dress. My father, suspecting she had some mental health issues, played along, suggesting that she may be in the wrong church. When that didn't work, he slipped off and called the police. In the meantime, the lady walked up to my soon-to-be brother-in-law and said, "You aren't going to leave me this time." When the police pulled up to the church, the lady spotted them and made a quick exit. Turns out she had a habit of pulling the stunt. My brother-in-law still occasionally reminds my sister that he had a choice on their wedding day, but still chose her. The bride fainted and hit her head hard enough to go to the hospital in an ambulance. No refunds, so they amazingly still had the reception. Pretty subdued. We had a few drinks and just left. Not a bad thing that happened for me, just really awkward. Went to wedding of someone from my church a few years back. When it came time to say the vows, he pulls out a sheet of paper and reads on for like 5 minutes, getting really intimate and pouring his heart out to her. It was kind of awkward TBH, but the icing on the cake was her response. When he was done, she just giggled loudly and awkwardly and got out ditto that's it. That was her wedding vow. So freaking awkward. Bride never showed up. My cousin was the groom and had about 500 people in attendance. He got on the mic and said there's no bride, so we had the party anyway. He married someone else 2 years later. I worked at a wedding venue for 4 years. Having to stop a bride's stepdad from hitting her over the head with a chair was a highlight. The whole room were just fighting with each other. The best man kicked the mother-in-law. Different wedding. Some dickhead bit the DJ because he refused to play a certain song. For me, the absolute worst one was when the newlyweds were arguing at the end of the night, in front of their young son. She admitted to cheating on him. It all came out there and then in front of his family and he was devastated. What is with this thread and people biting each other? There was this guy outside of the hotel walking up to groups of people in the smoking area, asking how much each person weighed. He was very overweight himself, and his jeans looked to be on inside out. He was severely underdressed for the occasion, and no one seemed to know him. Anyways, he would ask a person's weight, and then exclaim, "I can bench that," until one guy, I think he was a family member of the bride, got into an argument with him and started asking around if anyone knew this person, figuring that he was a wedding crasher. That's when this gentleman decided to cut a deal with everyone. "If I can pick up that bench with my bare hands, can I stay for the party?" To which everyone agrees, because the bench was clearly bolted to the ground. So, he walks over, puts his hands on the bench, crouches down, and with all of his might, shoots his pants in front of everyone. He stood up and waddled off through the parking lot to never be seen again. I did hear throughout the night people talking about a guy who was on shrooms outside, trying to lift a bench. So, I guess he was also tripping balls. I'm so jealous to have not experienced this story firsthand. I ruined my cousin's wedding videos and I'll never live it down. When I was 13, my cousin got married and my brother was in charge of photography and video for the day. At some point in the day, my brother gave me the camcorder and told me to shoot and take video. Longer story shorter, I was unknowingly recording when myself and another cousin were talking about girls at the wedding, and as one girl walked by I said I would frick that girl in the fricking butt. 1 week later, The whole entire family decided to watch the video of the wedding, and I have never felt so freaking embarrassed in my life. No, I never actually fricked that girl in the freaking butt, but my family occasionally likes to ask, "Hey, you gonna frick that girl in the freaking butt?" whenever I bring a new girl around. Usually while she's standing right next to me. I'm 25 now and it's been a funny 12 years at my expense. Suckers. And you learned the most important lesson about electronic media. The mic is always on. The groom was drinking heavily, and by the time the cake was supposed to be cut, he was passed out at the back of the room. The bride was crying hysterically. Dad stepped in and cut the cake with the bride. Former maitre d'hotel. There was like an 8-year-old boy who had loads of confetti in his hand, so I didn't think much of it. Turns out he thought it was sugar paper and ate all of. He then proceeded to projectile vomit everywhere through the middle of the ceremony. Was one of the funniest and most disgusting moments of my life. I'm just trying to imagine his thought process. Well, the first one didn't taste like sugar, let's try another. No, just paper. Maybe this yellow bit over here. Well, I'll be darned. Let's try the red. After arriving 45 minutes after the ceremony was to begin, during the ring exchange, the groom gets this blank look and says he didn't know he was supposed to buy her another ring. Still slipped off her wedding band and handed it off to the preacher. This is probably something they should have discussed beforehand. The wedding ring isn't supposed to be a surprise. Nervous groom stood with his legs straight for too long. Fell forward and knocked himself out cold, hitting the first step to the platform with his head. For the bouquet toss, a middle-aged guy forced his middle-aged girlfriend out onto the floor, then stood by her so she couldn't leave. The bouquet was caught by an excited little girl. The guy proceeded to yank the bouquet out of the little girl's hands, gave it to his middle-aged girlfriend, then ran off the floor cheering loudly to high-five one of his buddies. The little girl ran away crying. Just as the bride started walking down the aisle, her grandmother had a sudden cardiac event. We had to stop the procession and start CPR in the aisleway. What's worse is that we were in a large park, and people calling 911 couldn't give the address. I ran to the ranger's station, but it was locked. I broke a window screen and crawled through to use the landline Ms. could trace and respond. She didn't make it. As an added bonus to the horrible situation, I later found out the ranger had placed a hidden camera in the women's restroom where the girls got ready dressed for the wedding. He served jail time. At least the creep ranger didn't get away with it. I was at a wedding where one of the bridesmaids had gotten married a month earlier and thought it was a good idea to change out of her dress into her wedding dress for the reception. We in the wedding party told her to change back. She decided to stand at the head of the buffet line and tell each and every one of us as we came through the line how she felt. F you, I F'd your husband, you're a C. It goes on and on. Booze was involved, so you can imagine how it was. She refused to change out of her wedding dress until one of the other bridesmaids locked her in the bathroom and told her to change or it was going to get physical. She changed and left not long after. The rest of the reception was a fantastic time. Was at a wedding this summer. The groom's family absolutely tore their son brother apart during the speeches. They didn't say one loving thing, and went on to talk about all the mistakes he made during this life. The worst thing they brought up was how he was responsible for a car accident that put someone in a coma. I was cringing. Oh, and one more travesty. Dinner wasn't served until 10 p.m. Having that sort of family would be reason enough to elope. If the bride didn't want to elope, then offer a destination wedding for her and her closest family if they really really wanted to, and you could afford it. One of my best friend's weddings. The groom got so drunk that he straight disappeared from the reception. Crap got real awkward when it was time for the wedding to be over. The venue was kicking us out and the bride and groom were supposed to take off in their vintage car and drive off to their honeymoon suite. The music went off, lights went on, and it turned into the guests searching for the dang groom. My husband finally found him in the parking lot, basically face down on his lips. He helped him back into the wedding, which was basically the most awkward walk of shame past the bride's glaring dad and grandfather. The groom was too drunk to drive. Bride's grandfather drove them to the hotel suite, which was a 30-minute drive. My friend, the bride, later told me that when they got in the room, her new husband, passed out cold on the bed and she had to wander the halls in her wedding dress looking for someone to unhook her dress for her so she could get out of it. She had to wander the halls in her wedding dress looking for someone to unhook her dress for her so she could get out of it. This is the saddest part. I went to a wedding in a huge manor house on a cliff overlooking the ocean. The house was lit up by big floodlights in the floor pointing up at the house. When it got dark, some guests ran inside to the bar dance floor and shouted at people to come outside and look. A man and a woman, who met for the first time at the wedding, were freaking below one of the floodlights but didn't realize that their gyrations were being projected 50 feet high onto the side of the house. A perfect shadow of two shaggers. They were very embarrassed when they found out. Real life shadow pee on the side of a house isn't exactly what you would expect at a wedding. Friend's wedding a few years ago. The DJ had screens up for slideshows of the bride and groom that were played during some of the songs. Fine. DJ screensaver was Girls Gone Wild style videos. We saw lots of tea on those screens. This isn't a best wedding ever thread. We were partying in Puerto Vallarta, and there was a beautiful wedding going on at the hotel next door. A friend of mine was pretty drunk, then just sprinted for the wedding. He hopped the wall, blasted through the seating arrangements, then body slammed the like 6-foot tall wedding cake. He spent the next 2 days in Mexican jail, and will forever be a freaking prick in my heart. I'm guessing this isn't the only story of him making great decisions while drunk. Ex-boyfriend of the bride got super drunk at the reception and started rambling loudly, heard by half the reception hall, about how the marriage was wrong and how she was the love of his life. He was there with his then new, presumably imminently ex-girlfriend. Frick knows why she invited him. If there's one thing that I learned from watching How I Met Your Mother, it is that I should never invite my ex to my wedding. Or crap happens. I get it, guys. This doesn't happen with everyone. The replies to this comment prove me wrong. PLS, stop responding. I wasn't expecting so many replies. For the love of everything that is holy. PLSSTAHP. My husband's brother having a seaside wedding. Our almost 2-year-old was the ring bearer. He passed off the rings to the best man. Dad then toddled away off the cliff. It was probably 60-80 feet drop to the beach below, but he luckily got caught up in the bushes, and husband snatched him up. He was buckled into his stroller after that. Kamikaze kid. I think my heart stopped for a second until I reached the end of your post. Glad he was okay. At my wedding, I'm Australian. We were getting to the speeches part of the night, but were waiting for me to come back from the toilets. The meal had not quite agreed with me and I was dealing with the consequences. My buddy who was being MC was currently stalling the 110-ish people and decided it'd be funny to come find me, wandering mic in hand. He enters the toilets and asks how much longer I'll be. I didn't know he had a mic, and that everyone was waiting for me. So replied quickly back with an angry frick off, see, I'm doing a crap. I'll be done when I am freaking done. Much to the horror of the people in the next room. Brother and sister-in-law thought it would be fun to have their dogs walk down the aisle after their flower girl spread the flower petals. The dogs thought midway down the aisle was the perfect place for a crapping photo op on the white runner. My dog was at my wedding. At least ours waited until we were saying our vows before she dropped a deuce. Nobody caught a photo of it happening. Crying shame, because that would have been on our thank you cards. My cousin's mother-in-law told my cousin that her dress was ugly and then called the next day to ask if they had fricked. Super awkward. My cousin is super religious and modest and was waiting for her wedding night to do anything, so it was extremely embarrassing for her. I was friends with a couple that had split right before my wedding. I knew I couldn't invite both of them and I was closer friends with guy, but he decided to move out of state after the breakup, so I invited the girl. Let's call her Kelly. Kelly shows up with a new younger knockoff version of her recent ex. Cool. Whatever. Kelly is about 5 feet 11, 120 pounds, maybe. Good looking girl. Long legs. She decided to wear a mini pleather skirt, which wouldn't have been too bad. Only there was also a 2-inch slit up the back. A little much for a wedding, but whatever. The whole wedding family members, friends and co-workers kept asking me who Kelly was and if I knew. She was basically flashing all her goodies to the whole guest list all night, including the children. See, I was too distracted by my wedding to notice that Kelly also decided to not wear underwear. So every time she sat down during the ceremony and reception, her chonch and butt would be visible for all behind her to see. Thanks, Kelly. Now my 90-year-old great-grandma knows all too well what your chonch looks like. When you're 5 feet 11, sometimes you learn the hard way that clothes are designed for women who are 5 feet 6. Sorry, your wedding was a peep show. At my own wedding reception, I saw my wife's grandma, who was about 98, very slowly and with a terrible sense of inevitability fall sideways off her chair. She remained in a sitting position but just slowly tilted sideways till she was on the floor, still in the exact same pose. It sounds crappy, but all I could think was, fuck's sake, don't die at our wedding, please don't die at our wedding. Luckily she was fine, and lived for another few years to see her 100th birthday. I thought my wife's grandma died at our wedding. THX for the karma, Grandma Mary. When my brother and new wife got to the hotel apologized for the rowdy lot in the bar. My brother said it's fine as they were our family. That's hilarious. My friend got married around age 21. Neither he nor the bride had much money, so the wedding was modest but still very nice. They did have a lovely three-tier cake though. The ceremony goes fine and the bride will cut the cake, music is playing. She was a dainty, tiny little thing. Maybe 5 feet 2 inches and 100 pounds soaking wet. If she swatted a fly, it might not even notice. She approaches the cake with a knife, barely touches it, and boom, the whole thing immediately collapses. All 3 tiers somehow, all over someone's elderly grandmother who was seated right by the ill-fated cake. That old lady, who had barely moved throughout the whole affair, shot out of her chair like she was fired from a cannon, screeching bloody goddamned murder and sending cake shrapnel all over those nearby. Another close friend and I watched the whole thing from close range and were paralyzed and purple from hysterical breathless laughter, as were many of the other guests. I later heard the bakery refunded them for the cake due to its not up to code construction. They should have charged them double for generating memories that no one there will ever forget. It was the man of honor, like a maid of honor, except a guy. There was also still a best man. During the man of honor speech, the guy repeatedly said the name of the bride's ex instead of her new husband. 3 times. When I first saw bride and bride's ex, I knew they were perfect for each other. Stuff like that. And he caught himself, too, every time. He was insanely embarrassed, but he still did it 3 times throughout the speech. It was so awkward watching it happen. Probably the biggest social train wreck I've ever seen. Plot twist, man of honor was the bride's ex. Friend's wedding. The bride's nephew, about 7, I think, was the ring bearer. Instead of sitting at the front after he made it down the aisle, he decided to do karate moves in front of and sometimes behind the couple during the entire ceremony. He's in almost all their photos. An alarming number of you are worried that this was you. The boy's still too young to really be on Reddit, I think, so you're probably safe from anonymous internet judgment, lol. Now he's part owner of a bar in Philadelphia. Not that bad, but the maid of honor, wife's sister, speech at my wedding. Holy crap, this was hands down the worst, most cringy speech I have ever heard. Right before, my best man's speech was great, touching, and only took about 5 minutes. First thing she says, well, I'm not gonna get all fake and sappy like that last speech. No one laughed. He and I looked at each other like WTF. She had 2 pages of typed up words in her hand, shaking, and still managed to ramble on for 20 minutes. 20. You could tell she never actually practiced the whole thing. She lost her place a few times, started crying a few times, her family kept telling her she was doing great, and she told them quite audibly to shut up. She said she was a spicy meatball, said that like 10 plus times, referenced how she almost slept with me and that her sister is lucky she didn't or we wouldn't be together, talked about all these negative experiences with my wife, and the one nice thing she said was, but you're my sister and I love you, which made her cry again. God, I just wanted it to end. That 20 minutes was a freaking eternity. The wedding ceremony for Lance and Vicky was ending when the priest said, I now introduce you to Vance and Licky, husband and wife. My dad's friend's son got married when I was a teenager. He's a really cool guy and we played Nintendo a lot whenever we visited. Anyway, the embarrassing story is about his bride. She decided that she wanted to sing to him at one point during the ceremony, so she chose the song Wind Beneath My Wings by Bette Midler. Midler is an alto. The bride was a high soprano. Unfortunately, she couldn't sing very well, either. So for several minutes she squeaks this song out while he's standing there with the most awkward look on his face. I think everyone felt embarrassed. I know I did. The good thing is that they're still happily married and have a daughter. Why people think singing to their so on their wedding day is not cringy is beyond me. At the reception, the bride received a tip to go out to the parking lot where she found her new husband making out with his ex-GF. The ensuing fight came inside the hall and the party screeched to a halt. Both families were displeased and stuck him with a lot of bills. We kept our gift. Good on whoever gave her the tip. That's freaking balls. I was an attendant in my best friend's wedding. Her father walked her down the aisle and while he was not visibly drunk, he had a hard time walking behind her to sit in the pew. He stepped on her dress, ripping it from her back down to her butt. Her thong was red. They had to stop the wedding so that she could find safety pins. Comma, her thong was red. Details like these makes wedding stories worthwhile. Went to my cousin's wedding and the groom and men wore tuxedo shirts and when they got to the I do's he said AWW crap, I guess. Shortly after eating they proceeded to light the trash on fire and shoot clay pigeons behind the house after heavy drinking. Good times. My friend got married, and apparently the bride's best friend had some past issues with the groom's cousins. It was tense all night until a fight broke out between them. The groom's cousin started throwing punches and the bride's friend brought out a knife. He ended up cutting his hand after three guys had to pry them apart. Pretty interesting, but got super awkward once the bride started hysterically crying after screaming for about 3 minutes. Grandmother broke her ankle dancing. Didn't want to bother anyone so sat down for the rest of the night. And at 11 p.m. 3 hours later. Welsh grannies are hard. I once worked a wedding where one of the guests thought it would be perfectly reasonable to change her baby's crappy diaper on a table where other guests were eating. I offered to show her the restroom where we had a baby changing station or even an empty banquet room. But the disgusting bee said she was finished and had the audacity to shove the dirty diaper at me and tell me to throw it away for her. The other guests looked both disgusted and mortified. Ack. Witnessed almost the exact same thing while working a wedding. Except it was the table that the actual wedding cake was on. Even worse, the whole thing appeared to be done for a bizarre photo op. We tried to stop it before it began, but people with this little common sense generally cannot be reasoned with. What did that bee do at your wedding? By the time of our wedding, my husband's 33-year-old sister was still single and she hated that her younger brother was getting married first. How did she deal with it? By trying to sabotage my wedding. The night before our wedding, she got s-faced and, while ugly crying, told my husband that it was supposed to be her wedding and it wasn't fair because she'd be able to plan a much better wedding than ours. That would eventually prove to be false, as she finally got her on again, off again boyfriend to propose, by giving him an ultimatum. We had a small elegant outdoor wedding at a mountain lodge, and my sister convinced some family members on my husband's side that the dress code was casual, so they showed up in jeans, t-shirts, and hoodies. I was beyond upset with them for readily taking my sister's word without double checking with us. Luckily my photographer was sensible enough to exclude them from the pictures as much as possible. At our reception she went around complaining to our guests about how cheap our wedding was. My husband's side is used to those typical church and banquet hall weddings and ours was way different. But still, it's rude to crap all over someone else's wedding at their wedding. The lodge had a hot tub on the property, and near the end of the night when people were starting to leave, she changed into her bathing suit and chilled in the hot tub. This was planned ahead of time because she thought to bring her bathing suit there. My husband and I don't really talk to her anymore. Yikes. Also, what kind of idiot turns up to a wedding in a hoodie? Even if it's casual, surely you want to look good. Tell me which is the worst. My mother refused to wear the color that I asked her to wear, which my mother-in-law and all my bridesmaids wore and which matched my table decorations. Instead she wore a sparkly silver sequined gown which had the express purpose of upstaging the bride. Me, Then my sister-in-law threw a hissy fit because when we went into a small room with the rabbi for a blessing, only the wedding party was allowed to come. It was supposed to be intimate and a small, hence the small room. Since sister-in-law couldn't come, she didn't let her husband, who was a groomsman, my husband's brother, come either and made a big noisy stink about it. Third, my husband's cousin somehow got the band to honor her for her birthday with a long speech and a special dance for her and her husband, even though it was also my cousin's birthday and was also my best friend's anniversary and it was my freaking wedding, not her birthday party. Overall, my wedding was magnificent, but there were definitely three B's there. I say the third one is the worst. Kick the B out. Let her have her own party if she wants to be the center of attention. My sister's wedding. Our relatives on my father's side are not the greatest, just not really respectable people. They're on the poorer side, which isn't a problem, but their attitude is. They think the world owes them something. My parents both grew up in poorer families, but worked really hard and became pretty successful. Because of this, my sister and I constantly got comments from our cousins that were just straight crappy, constantly making us feel bad for being better off. To combat this, kids were not allowed, only aunts and uncles. It bummed us out because one family on my dad's side is actually awesome, but the rule stood because of the crappy ones. So of course, the worst of all, our aunts brings her freaking kids. Her two daughters share her bratty entitlement. It was awful, and now caused a rift with the family we like because their kids weren't welcome. But they are. Another crappy aunt tried to make the entire event about her. She was pissed that the guests of honor were my parents' best friends and not family. My grandmother introduced the best friends to everyone, and when it got to that aunt, she stuck her nose up, turned around and walked away. The best friends cracked a joke as she walked away, and everyone was laughing at her, which was nice. Well, I have three crappy aunts, and they basically tried to destroy the evening. Now my family makes themselves busy during holidays. My sister lives in another state. My parents leave a few days before Thanksgiving to go to their summer home, and don't return until after New Year's. That leaves me alone to make excuses why I am not attending their holiday parties. Channel, you're in a Phoebe. I wish I could, but I don't want to. Super useful. Also, sorry you have such a crappy extended family. Wife's friend got his face drunk. Told groomsman to go frick his grandma, ripped her dress while twerking, and tried to get in my car as we were leaving for our honeymoon. Good times. My sister's wedding. The groom's grandma and female cousins. Parents are deceased. Wiped their feet on my sister's dress train during pictures. Then stole all the bottles of wine that had the labels customized to read the wedding vows of the groom's parents. Then proceeded to bring back hard liquor, do shots, and grind on the DJ while he was playing bass booming hip hop that my sister and her husband explicitly said they didn't want. After those shenanigans, they also threatened to physically assault my sister and my mother. My sister didn't confront them because she didn't want to give them the pleasure of seeing her hurt or angry on her wedding day. The groom is no contact with his cousins, and low contact with his grandparents. My sister hasn't seen any of them since the wedding. The grandma wasn't doing any grinding, but the groom found out later that she orchestrated the whole thieving of the wine bottles, which occurred while my mom and sisters stepped away after the ceremony. Because the woman who was going to perform was dying in hospice, and we needed to say goodbye. My sister is white, my Bill is black, and I don't think his family is xenophobic. I just don't think they liked my sister. Didn't show up. We had set up the tables so that we had an even amount on both sides of the dance floor, and this one family who RSVP'd no, lets my in-laws know about 2 weeks before the wedding that oh, we can come now. Is that okay? My in-laws said sure. This made my wife insane. We had to redo the seating for her whole side of the family, add a table and rearrange everything. Well, the day comes and they don't show up, send no gift and never mention it. We had a very small ceremony and a very intimate wedding dinner with our families. My one of my closest friends invited herself. I should have said no, but I felt bad. Plus, I had just recently told her she wasn't gonna be the maid of honor at my wedding reception, which was couple months away. So I thought maybe this would make up for it. One extra person wouldn't hurt, would it? Biggest freaking mistake. We had a long day, and she started drinking early, and could not control her alcohol. I had asked her to keep my parents company since they're here from a different country and they don't speak a lot of English. All she focused on was the many bottles of wine. By the time we sat down for dinner, she was slurring. In the middle of dinner, everybody was enjoying themselves. She told my husband that he's taking me away from her and that she's mad at him because of it. We laughed it off and I asked the server to limit her wine. A little later, she stared at my parents who were having a good time, leaned over to me and asked, "Is your dad still cheating on your mom?" Note, my parents went through a rough patch couple years back and my mom insisted that my dad was not being honest with her. There was no proof and to say my mom is dramatic is an understatement. They got over it, and still together now. Nevertheless, that period of time was very difficult for me. When she asked me that question, I just stared at her blankly. Part of me was so embarrassed and worried that someone else may have heard what she said, but more so it just brought back bad memories about my parents' marriage on my own wedding. It literally ruined my mood. I was horrified. I straight out told her that it was inappropriate to mention that. She was embarrassed, so she kept drinking more and more. She then started to call her boyfriend to come pick her up. He immediately got annoyed at her because she has been drinking so much and hung up on her. She proceeded to call him 38 times, eventually sitting at the table crying on the phone while both my family sat there awkwardly not knowing what to do. Eventually, her BF agreed to come get her. I had to gather her stuff and walk her out. She did not say bye or thank you to anyone. The cherry on top was that she realized how stupid she was and called me 10 times that night to try to talk to me on my wedding night. I know it's no consolation, but I'll give her 5 points for trying to apologize. This, however, is nothing to the 100,000 points she's lost for her behavior. That B didn't come. My mother-in-law was upset that my parents renewed their vows during our reception. We were married on my parents' 40th anniversary. They were poor and went to the justice of the peace. Never had anything formal. Never even had a formal picture taken in 40 years. My mom died last year, so giving her the chance to feel like a bride, even if it was several decades after she was married, is something I will be proud of and happy about forever. One of my husband's old friends was a bridesmaid. We were super laid back bridesmaids, didn't have to buy dresses. Nothing was mandatory to attend, etc. This woman would message me non-stop about her problems we can't make it to. We had to borrow clothes for the wedding, we don't have a ride, can your fiance pick us up, etc. I was cool about everything. Come to what you can. Yes, we'll make sure you have a ride. Wear what you have, it's not a big deal. But to her, everything was a big deal and I spent more time dealing with her drama than my own things that needed to be done. After the wedding she turned the crazy up to 11 and started picking fights on social media. I very quietly removed offending posts and limited my posts that she could view without unfriending her. She flipped out. I said that I would like for us to remain civil for the sake of my husband, who was a friend of hers, but requested that she stop involving him in our arguments and that we limit our interactions on social media. Then I was bombarded with things like, "Well, at your wedding your friend said I didn't get pretty flowers in my bouquet just because I didn't show up to your stuff." She then posted screenshots of our private messages, like a 12-year-old. Luckily she came off looking worse. My husband told her that she needed to act like an adult, and we cut off contact when she failed to do so. Some people are just nutty, crazy, or just wanted to freak your husband. Not my wedding, but my brother-in-law's. Bill and his wife were the first of 3 siblings to marry. Mill insisted, and got her way, on the following. 1. Bill and his wife hire an aunt with a really good camera to take the wedding photos, but she showed up with a point and shoot. I am a professional photographer, with the core of my business being weddings. At Mill's insistence, I was not allowed to attend anything but the ceremony and reception. 2. Bill and his wife weren't allowed to have any alcohol or dancing, because those things make people sinful. Everything was done by 6 p.m. When my husband and I got married, we did everything how we wanted and didn't care what Mill said. Professional photographer, drink tickets, a dance, etc. The evening went without incident. Coincidentally, or maybe not, Mill divorced about 1.5 years later, to marry a man she was having an affair with. He turned out to be a convicted diddler. Mill told us it's just a sin, and made all sorts of justifications when we confronted her about her deception, dishonesty and apparent disregard for the safety of her grandchildren. No one in the family talks to Mila anymore. Maid of honor. She was great leading up to the wedding, very helpful, and liked being involved in the planning. But when the big day came, she became a whole other beast, scowled the entire ceremony, started telling other members of the wedding party that the bride slapped her across the face. She didn't. She killed a mosquito on the maid of honor's back. Then she complained that she wasn't in enough of the photos. Finally at the reception, she continued spreading lies to the mother of the bride and the wedding party and anyone else who would give her attention. The mother of the bride was gullible and believed it all. This led to the bride being berated by her mother and the wedding party for things she didn't do, inside the women's restroom where nobody else could get to her, not even the groom. The bride cried the entire night of the wedding, and the next day the maid of honor emailed the groom with a list of reasons why the bride was a horrible person. This is a two-parter. My grandmother made my sister late to her reception, wanted to give her a large check as a gift, but insisted that her and my, sorry, but spineless, grandpa give her that gift in private. Everyone left the house for the venue, and an hour later, my sister arrives. Apparently my grandmother essentially held her hostage with the dang thing, and only gave it over after giving her a huge lecture and saying a bunch of sadly typical, poisonous things. The start of my sister's reception was no bride, and then an upset bride putting on a strong show for people. I know her well enough to know it when I see it. The next part is worse. My great-grandmother didn't show up to the wedding or reception. That stung. As you might imagine, she only lived around an hour away, but my grandmother had mentioned that my Gigi didn't want to make the trip. We found out later that this was because my grandmother told her own mom that my sister didn't care if she made the trip or not, so she stayed home for her uncaring great-granddaughter's wedding. Hurt all around. Not even the worst crap my grandmother's done in the last 15 years. I want to love her, but I'm of the belief that the world will be a better place when she's not in it anymore. She's too consistently toxic to anyone naive enough to let her close, and it makes me more sad than angry these days. Came up to me at the reception and said, OMG wow, your dress is stunning. I mean, my wedding dress is my favorite wedding dress of course and is way prettier than anyone else's. As she looked me up and down, but I actually like yours. The emphasis on the actually sounded like she was surprised I could look good in a dress. B. In this case, I was that B. At my friend's wedding, they had a bench for people to sign and wrote well wishes on. On the underside, I wrote, if you can read this, you two must be in a terrible fight. Now kiss and make up. Drunk me, and sober me too. Thought it was funny, since it's not obvious. The happy couple did not find it funny. Oops. No, that is hilarious. At my wedding, my wife decided she wanted squares of fabric instead of a guest book, which were later turned into a quilt. Her favorite square if from an anonymous well-wisher who wrote, may all your ups and downs be under this quilt. Bridesmaid bitch face spent the morning telling my wife it was pouring. The aisle of our outdoor wedding was a trough of mud, and her gown was surely going to be ruined before she got up the aisle. Bridesmaid, normally narcissistic and insufferable, went into damage control mode and gave bridesmaid bitch face stupid tasks to do to keep her away from the wife while preparations finished. Turns out the rain cleared out in plenty of time for the lawn to dry, and all we had to do about the middle aisle was move where the seats were set to the opposite side of the oak we were wet under. Not my wedding, but a close friend's. She had 6 bridesmaids. 2 were pains in the butt. 1 called her constantly leading up to the wedding to cry about how she was single and to beg the bride to invite more single guys that she knew. Other 1 put up a stink about not wanting to wear the jewelry the parents of the bride bought for everyone, then refused to wear the same color nail polish as the other bridesmaids. This wasn't the bride's request but a suggestion from the other bridesmaids. The bride knew she wasn't as close to all of us and offered to seat her at a different table with people she knew better. She chose to sit with us, then complained that we drank 3 bottles of wine between 10 people. Yelled at the bride because she had a personalized thank you to every member of the wedding party. Gave a stink eye all night, then left minutes into the reception without saying bye to anyone, including the bride and groom. He attempted to tip a drink on my best man, the best man's mum, and longtime family friend. Had to stop him. He wasn't happy. Pretty sure he also spewed in toilets. Not my wedding. It was my ex-brother-in-law's. His mother claimed to be a self-employed caterer, and while she had worked in the industry in the past, she had no actual business to speak of at the time. She just had a normal domestic kitchen with no facilities to prepare or store large amounts of food and a rather cavalier attitude to cleanliness. She already had a very dodgy track record with her previous attempts. After insisting on catering for my ex's 21st Street, she had given a couple of people food poisoning and delivered a quiche with mold growing on its base. She insisted on catering her son's wedding, but he was refusing. He knew that she couldn't possibly do a proper job of it, and besides, he wanted his mother at his wedding as a guest and not as paid help. So she was told that a professional caterer was going to be employed. On the big day, everything was going well, and while the caterer was setting up for the evening party, the mother accosted me and asked me and my ex to run her home in my car. When we got there, she had prepared a whole load of food which she wanted to take to the party. Despite my protestations, she insisted. So we loaded up a huge pot of curry, a gigantic trifle, and about half a dozen other plates of random food. When we got back to the venue, she asked us to unload it all and add it to the paid catering. I managed to grab the groom before we took anything in, and he flipped. Apparently, he and his bride had already had a big argument with her and insisted that they were not serving curry at their wedding. Whoever made it, he sent my ex inside to keep his mother busy while we hauled the curry across to the other side of the car park and poured it down a storm drain before throwing the pot in a builder's skip. We attracted the attention of a group of teenagers that were hanging around on the car park, and he handed them the huge trifle and told them to get rid of it for him. All of the smaller dishes ended up going inside, including a rather odd looking cake with bright green icing. She didn't notice that the curry and trifle were missing until it was time to eat. We all pleaded ignorance and suggested that the real caterers had removed them, or someone had stolen them. When we left for the evening, several of the cars and the venue windows were smeared with trifle, courtesy of the gang of teens. So we put the blame on them for sneaking in and stealing the food. Everybody who ate the weird looking green cake got food poisoning. I seriously want to know how someone manages to frick up cake so badly that it gives people food poisoning. Told my wife and I less than a week before the wedding that she couldn't go. She was a bridesmaid, because she'd gained weight and her dress didn't fit anymore. Then she showed up unexpectedly as a guest and awkwardly avoided us the whole night. She's my cousin. Friend's wedding 2 years ago. Outdoor wedding. The groom's mom is overbearing, to say the least. She's the mom who comments on every single one of your Facebook posts. The mom who texts you at all hours for the simplest of things. She just would never shut the heck up. When it came time to give the speeches, she wasn't asked to give one on purpose. What does she do? Grabs the mic out of the father of the groom's hand and gives a 15-minute speech. The highlights of the speech were, she wants a grandchild by the end of the year. She is so proud that they allowed her to live with them when they buy their house. News to everyone at the wedding. She calls the father of the groom hot cute. She pretended to fall 3 separate times during the reception and screamed like she was being stabbed. The best part? She was in every single picture taken at this wedding. Even the bride and groom's. Not a single picture was taken without her in front of it. Overbearing to the maximum. 0/10 would not recommend. That B was my sister. She was going through a separation from her husband and was miserable, so, of course, had to be miserable. She complained about the venue. Complained about the dresses. I let all my girls pick out their dresses as long as they were black, so they would reuse them. Complained about the food. I made sure there was vegan food for her. However, to top it off, she took 2 morphine during hair and makeup, so that when we were doing the processional, the best man had to help her walk and stay upright. I should add that she has had chronic, lifelong pain issues and has somewhat of a tolerance. I forgot. And in talking with my husband last night about our wedding, I remembered that she also told the hair and makeup girls to go easy. I don't want to look like Chuchu the Chinese W. One of the girls was Asian. I was mortified and tipped them probably far more than I should have. People of Reddit who had a guest ruin the wedding. What happened? I worked weddings. The best was the estranged, divorced father hadn't been in the picture for 20 years and who was not invited that showed up. Recognize the bartender as his ex-wife's friend, and starts grabbing everything available to throw at her. Police escorted him off the premises. Servers at a restaurant I was the disbigat back in university came into the kitchen after the reception broke up, telling us that the groom's drunken father had just been loudly proclaiming that he was going to go watch his son frick his new wife. Jeez. Pity I missed that one. Wasner, but friends of mine tell the story of how the best man's speech involved telling everyone that he and the groom had been lovers since college and that if there was any real justice in the world the two of them would be getting married. At the reception, in front of everyone, sounded pretty freaking epic. At least he was polite and waited until after the wedding to ruin the wedding. Didn't ruin the wedding for everyone, but pretty bad. My dad got remarried when all of us kids were adults. His new wife had an adult son. My sister dated and slept with her now stepbrother. Later, when my stepbrother was marrying someone else, my sister decided on the day of the wedding it was her duty to tell the bride that she had slept with her fiancé. Somehow the day had to be about my sister. On. Off. My sister's wedding album looks like her sister-in-law was the star. Nearly every getting ready, speech, cake cutting, bouquet toss, even the I do's, she's either directly in the middle, has barged in and is smiling straight at the camera, or is standing there with her boyfriend of the month. My sister didn't want her as a bridesmaid, just did it because she was invited to be one to the guy the sister-in-law was engaged to before that boyfriend. My father-in-law repeatedly used my husband's ex-GF's name during his speeches, and when talking to me, his toast at the wedding was full of slurred speech, and a story about Mark and Alyssa and their budding romance and how adorable it was. I'm not Alyssa. Alyssa was his GF in high school. His parents got divorced when he was young. He was a severely abusive alcoholic, and I've met him twice outside of our wedding. He didn't see much of my husband after he was 12 years old. Very out of touch. That said, we had been dating 6-7 years before we got married. He should at least get my name right. Not ruined, so much as unexpected. My brother had an interesting toast at our wedding. He is genuinely a super friendly guy that everyone likes. He proceeded to get fairly drunk, and when his best man speech started, he proceeded to thank all for attending. Next, he had to thank the grandparents for attending and doing what they did, gesturing with air quotes, so that our parents could be here. Next was a thanks to the parents for doing what they did so we kids could all be here. He then mumbles God bless the mashed potatoes and drops the mic, stumbling off the dance floor. We had a good meal of prime rib and some of the best chipotle pepper mashed potatoes ever. The whole reception erupted in laughter and mom went to the chef to get the recipe, dubbed wedding potatoes. Gold potatoes, enough for 4 to 6 people. Heavy cream, 1/4 to 1/2 depending on desired constancy. Smoky gouda cheese, 8 oz, shredded and mixed in. Chipotle peppers in adobo sauce, 1/2 of the 6-ounce can, finely chopped. My friend got married and decided to have a private ceremony but an open reception, in a massive hayfield in Vermont. They invite a huge number of people, over 300 show up, and it's a predictable Apocalypse Now crap fight from 10 a.m. till around 6 p.m, when everyone is seriously liquored up. People in and out all day, with 4 constant groups, the direct family of mostly tipsy adults, the bride's sister's college friends, from the women's studies major and model UN team, the groom's home friends, who are all either farmers or animal breeders, and the bride's friends, the guys I came with, numerous interests but a mutual love of poking things with sticks. There are some minor altercations between the home friends and college friends, but it's a drunken fire party in the middle of nowhere, so some yelling and boisterous ideological disagreement was expected and encouraged by many. He was calling you a feminazi. You gonna go sort I am out. But it came to a head when a heated discussion turned to a girl getting hit with a hot coal shovel. Utter chaos. Multiple 911 calls, police cruisers from 3 different departments, and a couple of ambulances later, we had been given the order to disperse. The problem was that we were all blind drunk and shouty, so after a few arrests and a stern tongue lashing from the statties, we put to bed several people well beyond the legal limit and sent home a lot of questionable people. What about the girl hit with the shovel? Well, the guy had no idea it was the recently used coal shovel and just wanted to smear a little dirt on the girl. She had yutz to vodka cranberry on him. He's a veterinarian and dragged her off, apologizing profusely, and fixed her up inside of an hour. The EMT didn't even bother taking the dressing off. Unfortunately, you can't undo 15 near simultaneously 911 calls. Both of them being too drunk to drive, they stayed the night, and we found them in the same freaking sleeping bag come morning. M. How about the wedding being ruined by itself? I was dating a girl whose cousin was getting married. Cousin was an obese goth chick getting married to a dude even bigger than her. We show up on the day of the wedding. I 100% promise this is serious. They've secretly decided it would be a gigolo wedding. Both bride and groom are in gigolo makeup, and the priest's speech thing included thank god for the insane clown posse, and thank god for Craigslist, where they met, I guess. It was weird. Not really ruining the wedding, but it certainly killed the vibe leading up to the wedding. I asked my brother to be my best man at my wedding. Brother and I, Catholic, GF, Episcopal. He says yes. Months after saying yes, he comes to us and tells us that he can't be the best man or even be at the ceremony because his priest tells him it will be a mortal sin for him to be a witness to the ceremony because I am not asking for dispensation and getting married in an Episcopal church. Okay, understood, sad, but if that's the way you see it, we'll deal with it. At this point I ask my best friend to be my best man and all is good, or so we thought. A couple months before the wedding, my brother starts a campaign calling my entire family and telling them they will be committing a mortal sin if they attend my wedding and explaining how my children will be bastards in the eyes of God and anyone who even sleeps under the same roof as us will be committing sin. WTF. I find all this out through cousins and friends and am in complete shock. Luckily I have a few cool family and they all show up for the wedding. Everyone had a what the heck is wrong with your brother question on the day of the wedding. But it was a great time with an open bar and live band. Here's the kicker of it all. My mom is Catholic. My pop is Episcopal. No divorces or any unhappiness. Just your normal suburban family. TLDR. Brother protested wedding to family members because of Catholic versus Catholic light. My mom stole my marriage license. I got married on Sunday. My aunt was taking flash photography the entire time, even though my officiant made the announcement about no photos or videos, and my photographer couldn't get some of the shots I wanted. My mom and my aunt were also being total B to everyone and all around really bitter and snobby. Then we did the signing of the license. I set it in my purse and walk away to get some wine. I come back and my mom is going through my purse. She said she was getting some gum because the brisket was too dry. It was only after she left that I realized I couldn't find it. She freaking took it. Now I have to get another one. They didn't ruin the wedding, but did ruin a couple pictures. An aunt and her family are notorious for showing up, eating all the food, stealing some drinks, and leaving. Her one son, nice guy that he is, has addiction problems and just can't keep it together. Her daughter is trashy and has a new boyfriend every week. She will show up to family events, make a gigantic plate of food, talk to no one, and leave. My family has a free vending machine in the man cave style basement and she will nearly empty before she leaves. So when my wife and I were planning the wedding, we didn't invite the one cousin with addiction problems, because at that point, he was in rehab. And we didn't let the girl cousin have a plus one because we were making some guest list cuts and she has trashy boyfriends anyway. Well, you can guess who shows up at only the reception. Skip the wedding part. We had an open liquor and be a bar, so the addiction cousin gets blitzed immediately. He was jumping into every picture he could and becoming a real nuisance. My dad, no relation to this cousin, almost had to kick him out before other family members took him away. The girl showed up to our semi-formal wedding wearing blue jeans and a t-shirt and her boyfriend of the week, who had the worst tobacco smile and looked like your typical redneck, was wearing a camo shirt and ripped jeans. She was filling her plate multiple times. She's not fat. She just takes as much as she can and stores it for later, while her BF got drunk. Then they had an awful macchiato session in the middle of the dance floor while groping each other. I went to the bar to get a drink and since I was a groom, people led me to the front. Her BF was there and was like, what the heck? Someone else said I was the groom and he was like, yeah, the groom. No way. Let's take shots. Everyone else that night was wonderful. It only takes a couple trashy family members to bring the mood down. But he said let's take shots. Not my wedding, but my boyfriend's, at the time, aunt's second wedding. His cousin Beth, the bride's daughter, got drunk and accused a 12-year-old girl of coming onto her man although her boyfriend wasn't even there. She shot glares at the kid the whole ceremony, and rolling her eyes during the vows. And at the reception, Beth cornered her in the bathroom, slurring her words and screaming and threatening she was going to knock her out. The poor girl was just crying, asking her what she did wrong. When her mom finally asked her to leave, Beth got mad that no one was taking her side. I don't know about you, but it's hard to feel bad for an overweight alcoholic screaming at a frightened 120-pound girl. It really brought the reception down, since there was only about 30 people who stayed after that fight. TLDR. Woman gets jealous of 12-year-old, screams and tries to fight her. I wouldn't say I ruined the wedding, but I definitely ruined one of my best friend's first dance. So my friend asked me to be the DJ at their wedding, which basically meant being the guy with the mic for introductions and hitting play on the playlist when the dance started. I should probably mention I freaking hate public speaking, but hey, anything for a friend, right? So it comes time to do introductions for the bridal party and start the first dance. So I say the names of all the bridesmaids and groomsmen during the introductions. They all did their stupid freaking dance that all people seem to do now. Then I get to the bride and groom. My first frick up was I introduce the bride by her maiden name right off the bat, then said frick into the microphone and corrected myself. My second frick up was I started to play their song for the first dance before I introduced them, so by the time they had walked into the venue and everyone stopped clapping, the song was 3/4 of the way over when they started to dance. So they danced for about 10-15 seconds. The song ended. I crap you not, this was an outdoor wedding, and as soon as the song ended it was dead silent except for the crickets in the field. Literally awkward crickets while everybody turned to look at me, like WTF you started the song too soon. So I was like, you want me to play it again? The bride and groom said no, forget about it. And that's how I fricked up my friend's first dance. That's not your fault. They didn't want to pay for a DJ, so they got an amateur performance. This was literally not your fault. You did good for having zero interest or experience. They were cheap and they got better than what they paid for. Not a guest, but there was a popular place for wedding photos. I was a groomsman groomspeople. So there's like 3 or 4 bridal parties waiting to take pictures. This one group was hilariously fricked up. All the groomsmen are completely and devastatingly drunk. Absolutely crap-faced. The new couple is having a knockdown, drag out screaming match, and the bride throws her bouquet into the lake. The mill is throwing a temper tantrum, and then sees all of us watching this delightful caper, and screams at us, "What are you looking at?" To which one of our party says, loud enough for them to hear, "Well, that was worth the price of admission right there." The new couple is having a knockdown, drag out screaming match, and the bride throws her bouquet into the lake. Obviously a marriage that will last. This is partly why divorce stats are BS. I don't think I ruined the wedding, but I got some awfully shameful looks. The reception was in a big barn on a horse ranch. Everyone had plenty to drink, especially me. During the speeches, about half of the guests were having their own conversations and I couldn't hear a dang thing. Drunken, self-righteous me decides to yell out a huge shut the frick up. Well, that is exactly what happened. You could have heard a mouse fart. The bride, my wife's friend, laughs it off, but I still feel pretty crappy about it. Nah, good on you, mate. Frick those inconsiderate assholes. I ruined a wedding one time, but it wasn't my fault. I swear it wasn't. I was a friend of the groom and I had an F-150, so I got asked to bring some chairs and a table to the reception hall, as people who own trucks are often asked to do. I agreed and was told I would be met there by a couple of women and a few guys to unload everything and place it. Cool. One of the women was pretty hot. I flirted a bit and she flirted back. She asked if I wanted to take a walk along the river that the reception hall was on. Sure. We walked for a while and talked, and it got hotter and hotter. We ended up making out on the riverbank for a bit and walking back to the hall, where I invited her to go for a ride in my truck. This was in rural Indiana. So in about 10 minutes we were along some numbered county road in the back of the truck, laying on a blanket and going at it. It was late evening and there was no one around. Then a car comes towards us. We laid still and waited on them to pass, but the car stopped and the girl from earlier got out and started screaming at us. Yep, the girl I was with was the bride. The wedding got cancelled. My friend punched me in the face. He found out later that I had no idea who she was and apologized. We are good now, and it was quite the scandal for a while. To be fair, you probably saved the groom from a lot of crap in the future. Plus, you didn't do it on purpose. So I'd say it was a blessing in disguise for everyone. This was not my wedding, but I was the flower girl. I know a while WGO but remember like it was yesterday. So bride and company show up at the wedding. Bride had her gown, flower girl, me, had her little dress, and the seamstress was delivering the bridesmaids' dresses to the wedding venue. Of course wedding party got there far in advance. Long story short, seamstress never showed up with the bridesmaid dresses. Nobody knew what to do. Total panic. While 7-year-old me sat in the corner, wasn't quite sure what the ruckus was about. So I tugged on the bride and said, they could wear those dresses, pointing to the cheer robes in the corner closet. Her eyes got wide, and they did. Wedding saved. LOL. TLDR. Bridesmaids' gowns didn't show. 7-year-old me asks the bride if they could wear cheer gowns. They did. Wedding saved. I hope the bride got a refund, but that was some quick thinking for a 7-year-old, and the couple have a funny story to tell about the wedding. Good job. One of my groomsmen almost got kicked out of the restaurant during the rehearsal dinner for loudly arguing with a hostess about whether or not the fish were really ethically sourced or not. I was almost this guest at my uncle and aunt's wedding in a registry office. Apparently, I was 2 years old and sitting in the front row with my mum and shouted yes various times when the guy performing the ceremony asked if anyone knew of any lawful impediment stopping my uncle and aunt from getting married. My mum loves to tell this story. But you're too. During the minister's reading right before vows, mother of groom let her phone ring loudly for like 30 seconds. Twice. My mother-in-law hates me. She spent any time she wasn't dancing during the reception staring daggers at me, complaining to the other guests at her table, and got in a very public shouting match with another one of our wedding guests after the reception. Even though she can't speak English, I was mortified and wanted nothing more than for her to crawl back to where she came from and never bother my wife and me again. Then a couple weeks later, she flew back home, and I haven't heard from her since. I have a story I can contribute. My wedding wasn't really ruined, but it almost was. My husband and I still haven't figured it out. Everything was going according to plan, aside from the stress of planning, of course, and a few weeks from the wedding. The owner of the venue was supposed to contact us and tell us the exact total to be paid. When he didn't, my husband called him up to ask how much we owed and the guy says nothing. You cancelled the wedding. What? After some back and forth, they figured out that someone who was not my husband had called the venue, claimed to be my husband, used his name and contract number, and cancelled the wedding. The only people who would have had access to that information is maybe one of the owner's employees, or someone in my husband's family. We tried to get the phone number from the service provider, but for obvious reasons they did not disclose. Other things to go wrong were his brother partially shaving his hair into a horrible haircut the day before the wedding without consulting us. The place we'd planned to take pictures at ended up being on fire when we drove there, so we had to take pictures elsewhere, and someone kept trying to hack into our wedding email account. We never figured that one out either. We also forgot to put the sand out, so during the ceremony my cousin had to sneak behind the stage and set it up. She managed without being noticed, and saved us the disaster. All in all, it was an average wedding, I'd say. The place we'd planned to take pictures at ended up being on fire. I love how casually you throw this out, like this is something that frequently happens to you. Or, man, it's on fire. I am not sure if she ruined it, but it is a fun story. At my wedding, my best friend was our best man. His wife, now divorced, was a very hot lush drunkenly SMS. It had been this way for years. She promised him that she wouldn't drink during the wedding or reception. So about halfway through the reception, she is out there on the dance floor grinding on my 50-year-old 300-pound uncle, just wasted and giving him tonge. Seems she had a flask hidden someplace. She then starts trying to make out with just about every guy she can find. My friend then collected his wife and had to leave. Now, on the way home she gets pee, and jumps from the car in motion and dashes down the street. She's a marathon runner, and my buddy lost her while turning around the car. She proceeds to go to a local bar and meet up with some women she knows from her work. They drink more and she gets in an argument with a woman another she knows that was at the bar. That woman leaves after my friend's wife attempts to get her to fight her. So, my friend's wife in her work friend's car chase them home. She ends up trying to kick in the woman's home door in all drunk and crazy. This woman finally opens the door and beats the crap out of my friend's wife. Her work friends had to take her to the hospital where my buddy finally got the call to go pick up his wife. Epic. That woman has a lot of rage to work through. One of the bridesmaids got insanely drunk. She was vulgar with little kids running around and ended up falling all over the place. It didn't ruin the wedding, but she pee me off. So here is my contribution. My husband and I got married 12 years ago and he and his sister ruined my wedding. To start, we lived in Oregon at the time and all of my family live in Georgia, so since I have a huge family who don't have the financial means to travel, and his family is very small, we went to Georgia to get married. The BS started as soon as we started planning. The sil would make comments telling us we should just get married like she and her husband on Christmas in a tiny church with a couple of people. She made a lot of other suggestions too about how we should do things. Then, while at my in-laws on Christmas morning, 9 months before our wedding, my husband asks his dad to be his best man. It was a very touching moment. His mom cried. Later that night, his sister corners him and asks why he doesn't make her husband his best man. The fight about that between the whole family on Christmas Day was really great. Lots more happened, but I'll move on to our wedding day. We are all getting ready at a rented beach house. Admittedly, my sil can really bring out the worst in my husband. He's stressed while getting ready and being in, but she's being passive aggressive and making everything about her. For photos before the wedding, we are meeting at a park. I am riding with my friend and he is going to follow. On the way to the park, we get lost. No worries, we will just go to the wedding venue. Somehow, my husband and his sister start fighting. With guests arriving in front of everyone, he's manipulating and pushing buttons. He's blaming her for my not showing up at the park for photos. I finally arrive to the venue with my very soon-to-be husband, hands in pockets and saying what the frick. My sister then tries going between my husband and his sister to defuse everything with my sil calling her an idiot, and then the minister threatens to leave because of the fighting. So after the ceremony, my sister-in-law has a horrible face in every single photo that includes her, and then had the nerve to tell me during my reception that her day was ruined and she would never speak to her brother again. So then, 2 days later, as I am packing to leave the beach rental, she comes into my room to tell me how hard the week has been for her. She goes on to say that there was God knows who sleeping on the couch, my best friend since 4th grade, and unruly, undisciplined children running around, my nieces and nephew, who really are great kids. Yet, my husband brings up renewing our vows occasionally, and while we do have a very happy marriage now, I have no desires for a vow renewal. Finally, a thread I can comment on. I recently had my wedding and we woke up together happy to be getting married, then my soon-to-be husband received a text from his mother. Disclaimer, his mother had waist-length black hair. It's a photo of her. She cut and colored her hair exactly like mine. Shoulder length, brown with blonde streaks. I was livid. Of all days to color your hair, and to do it on my wedding day. Fine, I let it go and decided to just forget it. Finally, it's the moment we all have been waiting for. I'm walking to the aisle, and we reach the front. The parents were called up so we all could recite a vow together. Our wedding was held in front of a riverbank, mind you. His mother then proceeded to walk around me near the pastor, instead of being with the other parents near the groom. She proceeded to loudly scream and fall. As she fell, she grabbed my hair and I fell with her inches away from the riverbank. My moment. Ruined. She got up and laughed and walked away while I was on the ground trying not to cry. To be honest, I don't remember anything else from the ceremony. I was seeing red. We no longer speak to one another, and I will forever refuse to speak to that woman. My husband stands by me on that decision. Till this day, when I think about my wedding, I tear up. She ruined it, and didn't even feel sorry for it. And those of you who say she fell and couldn't help it, after watching our wedding video, her husband and the pastor were holding her arms. She deliberately stepped back and fell. I know it doesn't help, but I think your feelings are completely justified. It sounds like she had every intention of making your wedding day her big look at me moment. If it was genuinely an accident, then she would have gone out of her way to help you off of the ground and made multiple apologies. At least your husband understands how you feel. My aunt had a very fancy formal wedding. Being four, adorable and related, I was the obvious choice for the flower girl. Here is the thing. It's a long day for the wedding party. Between hair, makeup, photos and long-winded Baptist vows, even the most attentive adult will get tired and bored. So here we are, standing lined up by the altar, and the preacher finally asks for objections. At that moment, I yawned as loud as my little lungs would allow. The once silent room filled with 200 friends and family erupted into laughter. That is when I noticed that 200 people were watching me, and I got scared and did what many scared 4-year-olds do. Peed, cried and tried to run away. So here I am, a pea-soaked 4-year-old in a pink taffeta dress, running about a church while my mother, the maid of honor, tries in vain to catch me. Running in heels and a ball gown is not easy. I still haven't lived it down 30 years later. That's priceless and innocent. The whole family will talk about how cute you were for the rest of your life. Sounds like you made a big fat bore of a wedding into a memorable day. My family flew in from Michigan. The wedding was in Phoenix. This was the first time my family met her side. Well, long story short, right before the speeches, my niece, 2, and her cousin's child, 2, were playing tag and running around like kids do. So, her cousin's child fell while running. Completely normal, and my niece went to help her up because she's a sweetheart. At this time, the cousin's father, let's call him Meathead, starts yelling and cursing at my niece until she starts crying murder. My sister runs over to see what's going on, and he tells her to watch her freaking kid. This was just after my sister complimented her family for being so nice and welcoming. It didn't ruin our wedding because we didn't hear of this until after. Apparently Meathead's ghetto wife was running around bragging to our guests. My aunt didn't really ruin the wedding, but she said something really ignorant at the reception. We had a small wedding and reception. Maybe 20 people. Close family and friends. I wasn't particularly close with my aunt and uncle, but my father died when I was young, so I thought inviting his brother to my wedding would be nice. And it was. I'm glad he was there. But his wife was a real tea. She was upset her entire family tree back to the Stone Age wasn't invited, so she was snotty and ignorant every time we interacted with her. Redditors that had their weddings ruined. How and what happened? I got hypothermia during the outdoor photography and missed the reception because I was in the hospital with my brand new wife, who was still in her wedding dress. That's a great story. My mom's best friend and maid of honor showed up the day of my mom's first wedding with her head shaved. Apparently she was in love with the groom, and this was her silent protest. The marriage only lasted 2 years, and the groom eventually married the maid of honor. Dang. Not a personal experience, but dad played in a band at a wedding where the bride's uncle dropped dead in her arms on the dance floor. Talk about bringing the party to a halt. My dad died at his nephew's wedding. Pretty much ended the party. Catering never showed up. Everyone was hungry. Also, the fireworks show that night was cancelled for the first time for whatever reason. I worked as a wedding decorator for 5 years, and while this is not my own wedding, it's still pretty bad. 2 years ago we did the decor for a really pretty ceremony, and halfway through the day we found out it was a surprise wedding. Basically, they were not engaged, but the bride planned the whole thing, and the groom showed up at the golf course thinking he was just playing a regular round of golf. Nope. He walked into his own wedding, saw her standing at the altar, and peaced the frick out, as he should have. I've also seen weddings where fist fights break out and we've had to call the cops. There was another where one of the guests was smoking inside and caused a fire, causing the entire wedding to evacuate into the rainy parking lot. Those, and countless glasses of wine spilled on wedding dresses. That happens a lot. My mom ruined my wedding. She ruined my brother's wedding too, but that's another story. She loved my fiancé until we got engaged, and then suddenly he wasn't successful enough. I wanted to get married at the yacht club because an uncle on my dad's side could offer a huge discount. She shot that idea down because she didn't want it to look like my dad's side paid for it. They're divorced. She tried to book the wedding at the same country club where her brother's recently failed marriage took place. She shot down every single one of my choices, from dress, to food, to colors and flowers. It got to the point where I hated thinking about my own wedding, and my husband finally suggested we just elope. So we booked a date with a judge, got married in secret, and asked our families to meet us for dinner, where we told everyone what we'd just done. My mom couldn't be angry about it in front of everyone without looking like a nutcase. 12 years later, no regrets. It's not about the wedding, it's about the marriage. This story is amazing. I love your conviction. I applaud your not being pushed around by a bitter person. I once DJ'd a half-black, half-white racist wedding. The groom was a skinny white nerdy looking guy and the bride was a larger African-American woman, both in their early 20s. From the start, I could feel a weird tension and hostility in the room, but thought okay, maybe something just happened at the ceremony that I missed, and shook it off. The night went on with a rather silent crowd, until it got to the speeches. First to go was the best man, who gave a warm-hearted, nice guy roast about the groom. Then the maid of honor with an average "I don't do speeches" love, laughter, happily ever after cheers and escape. Then came the parents of the bride. They both march up to the podium and the father takes the mic. "I love my daughter, and I know her to be a smart woman. I do not approve of this mixed crap." Done. Walks back to seat. My mouth is wide open at this point, while I hear major chatter from the crowd. The bride and groom must have been used to it, cause they just smiled at each other and looked on for the next onslaught. Father of the groom gets up to the podium. "So as most of you all know, my boy went off to university like a big shot for 4 years. 2 years in, he calls me and says, 'Dad, I've met a girl that I might marry.' I say, 'That's great, son, when can I meet her?' He brings her home for a weekend back in November, and all I can remember is sitting in the kitchen. He walks in, and she gets in behind him, and I'm like, 'Bam, what the heck is that? Didn't see this crap coming.' Frick it." Cheers, drinks his wine and sits back down. As soon as the dinner and speeches were done, everybody but the bridal party left, so I said, "You've got to haul all the booze you can drink, all your best friends, your new husband, wife, and a DJ. Might as well celebrate." So I set up karaoke and we all sang and got smashed for the rest of the night. Best wedding ever, despite the ignorant people. I'm glad the bride and groom were able to look past their family's hatred and still ended up getting married. It's good that they didn't let their family's opinions get in the way of their love for each other. The only mishap at my wedding was a friend videotaped the whole thing, but accidentally used the night vision feature. The video is pretty surreal, with everything super overexposed. With my pale skin, I ended up looking like one of the aliens from Cocoon. I wouldn't call that ruined, but it is pretty hilarious. My Phil's wife of the time attempted to ruin our wedding. The week before our wedding, she sent my mother an email that I, the bride, was am too good for her stepson. Then messaged me that she had decided not to wear the dress she and I had picked out. She refused to come to the wedding rehearsal, then showed up on the day of in a garish, skimpy outfit. She wouldn't speak to anyone or smile and just sat there with her arms crossed the whole day. We just ignored her, even when she threw away all the leftovers from the post-ceremony brunch that my husband and his best guys catered. They're all cooks, chefs. My Phil divorced her the following year. She sounds awful. I live in Colorado Springs, company. Friends of ours got married last year, 2013. They were going to get hitched the year prior, 2012, at the Flying W Ranch, a tourist attraction west of the Springs, but it burned down in a massive forest fire, so they rescheduled the wedding for the next year at a B&B in Black Forest, CO, just outside of C, Springs. Another forest fire happened and the mandatory evacuations prevented them from using that venue. They ended up poaching a public park near a pond for their big day instead. It turned out beautifully. Not mine but my sister's. She got married in a Catholic church. Her father-in-law is Venezuelan and doesn't speak English real well. He didn't understand the priest when he said not to get out your Brownings. That old crusty mother didn't even use the modern word for camera. Photography is not allowed inside Catholic churches, I guess. Anyway, her father-in-law stands up to take a photo. Man, this part kills me because he was so happy for his son and just wanted a photo of the moment. The priest slams his Bible down mid-ceremony and yells at him in front of everyone, not speaking barely any English, and all he was so confused as to why the priest was upset. He sat down looking so defeated and confused. After the ceremony, that crusty dong pickle was bragging about keeping his flock or some crap in line and that you sometimes have to yell at him. I still hate that guy. Out of all the stories here, this one maybe made me feel the saddest. Thankfully, crusty dong pickle cheered me up. I briefly owned a photo booth business that was hired mainly for weddings. The worst thing I saw was the wedding planner showed up drunk and or high and disappeared with the best man, brother of the groom, to go hook up. So no one was in charge and the ceremony had to be delayed while people went to find the best man. He also couldn't be found for his speech. The DJ delayed several times. They tried to have sex in my photo booth. So I took her by the arm and told her everyone knew she was wasted and they all hated her. Pretty harsh. But even I was pietor as I tried to help the bride and DJ coordinate the event. The wedding coordinator left during dinner. We did our best. But the wedding sucked and the bride was pretty upset that nothing worked out. She gave the DJ and I an extra $100 for our efforts. And laughed when I told her that I told off the wedding coordinator. Good on you for trying your best. Even if it didn't work out. My 3-year-old brother got loose and pulled the fire alarm during the ceremony. They definitely got their memorable moment. Our ceremony went off pretty much without a hitch, but someone pulled the fire alarm in the hotel on our wedding night. Never book a hotel for a romantic evening if said hotel is also hosting a prom. 50% of the people who RSVP'd didn't come. My brother-in-law who volunteered to DJ didn't actually bring any DJ equipment. So our reception was powered by Pandora. He also said he would video the ceremony and highlights of the reception but didn't bring his video camera. The florist forgot to deliver about 50% of the flowers. The reception venue took everything we discussed and then decided to do the opposite. Not enough tables, big weird glass centerpieces, no dance floor. And when we tried to get it fixed, the man who was sent to change out the tables stood outside the window of the reception hall angrily smoking cigarettes. I later spoke with a friend who has worked with that man who explained that that sort of behavior happens pretty much any time he is asked to do anything. So, we made a CD of music for my brother-in-law to play before the ceremony began. He insisted that he had something better. It was 2 songs played on repeat for about an hour. My immediate family was late to the wedding, including my sister who was a bridesmaid, and my mother and father. They had originally offered to help set up everything that morning, but I guess they just got a late start. My veil got lost the night before the wedding. It still has not resurfaced. After everyone was done eating and the cake had been cut, I dimmed the lights in the reception hall to change the atmosphere to a more fun party vibe and get people dancing. Everyone got up and left. It didn't go great, but my husband and I ended up married and we're still very happy together, and that's the most important thing. Still, I wish I'd saved the money from the whole thing and gotten married at the county clerk instead. My husband and I got pregnant while planning our wedding. My parents found out and moved the ceremony date closer. 2 weeks before the wedding we lost our child. Not only was that hard enough, my mother took it upon herself to cancel our wedding, catering, music, venue, guests, even sold my dress. We still kept our date. My parents refused to come to our impromptu wedding because, in their minds, we were only getting married because we were pregnant. Also, my aunt, father's sister, decided to tell my father that my husband threatened my mother. My aunt was mad because we moved our wedding date before my cousin's wedding. B marriage ended 9 months later, so my wedding was cancelled. Parents didn't come to my wedding. We had the nice intimate wedding we wanted with my husband's family and our close friends. We had an amazing picnic reception and a kick butt after party. Stress aside, we had our perfect day in the long run. I'm just a stranger on the internet, but bravo. Well done. Weddings should be about the bride and groom, not all that other extra stuff. So many things happened. My wife's parents were against us getting married. That's a long story for another time. First, my wife's brother is a pastor. She wanted him to perform the wedding. Her parents talked him into refusing. Then my Phil said he wouldn't walk my wife down the aisle. Then, when we were continuing to plan the wedding anyways, my Mill surprised us by showing up at our door. Luckily, she lived in Washington and we lived in Southern California, and my wife's brother, not the pastor, was able to warn us that she was on her way. We then found out that she had an appointment set up with our pastor and my parents to try to get the rest of them on their side to get us to call off the wedding. It didn't work, and my Mill was shocked when she was told by my pastor they're adults and can make this decision for themselves. I've known Strider 820 for years, and he's a good man. That was the final straw. We cancelled the wedding and went to the courthouse to get married by a judge, followed up by some breakfast burritos on the way home. When we got back, my Mill was trying to get my wife to get an annulment, including giving her information on how and where to get an abortion, in case that was a factor. My wife's brother was upset, saying that we were basically saying frick you to the whole family, to which we replied, well, yeah. Then her parents planned a joke of a wedding where we got no say in who, where or what was involved. They had the wedding in Washington, so it was cold, wet, and gray. That also caused the only people from my family to be there to be my parents. My best man was my wife's brother, who I didn't like at the time, as my best friend was too poor to make the trip to Washington. They basically didn't think we were really married until after that glorified party. It really would have been nice if they used all the money they used to throw a circus to help us with a down payment for a house or something instead. It has caused issues between me and her parents ever since. Meanwhile, we've been happily married for almost 9 years. Not a total loss for me, but here is the setup. We are non-denominational and our wedding was held at an outdoor venue in the summer. Here we all are. Friends and family gathered in suits and formal wear in the middle of June. It's a hot day and people were anxious to get started, so we went ahead and got everyone gathered around for the ceremony. The justice of the peace we hired has not shown up yet and I'm nervously waiting as the ceremony is supposed to start in a couple of minutes. The wedding time comes and goes. Still no justice of the peace. We try to call and go straight to voicemail. Meanwhile, everyone is now just standing around looking uncomfortable. A few jokes are cracked about it and we continue to wait. Several more attempts to call go unanswered. And now people are starting to get antsy. 30 minutes go by and now people are starting to offer to call people they know to perform the ceremony. 45 minutes after it was supposed to begin, people are starting to loosen up their ties, leave the area to find a cool place to hang out while they wait, and a couple of people straight up leave. I'm getting ready to call it when I see the Justice of the Peace strolling across the park towards us. She is in no hurry at all. When she arrives, she loudly proclaims that she had bowel problems and couldn't get out of the bathroom. When asked why she didn't call and let us know, she just shrugged and said, "Well, I'm here now, an hour late, but at least she showed." Once we get everyone organized again, we make it through the vows no problem. Then she asks to read a poem that she picked out for the wedding. It turns out that the poem is about the plight of the Native Americans. Neither my wife or I are Native American, so this particular poem, at this time, seemed odd and out of place. It seemed to go on forever and ever. It was some serious bury my heart at wounded knee crap. As soon as the ceremony ended, the Justice of the Peace signed the certificate and then took off. She disappeared without so much as a goodbye. I was just happy that she was gone. I wouldn't have paid her. It started with the invitations. Invited 102 people on my husband's side. 12 RSVPs. After talking to his mother, she assured me that more people would come. They just weren't used to RSVPing. We were having our wedding in his hometown so his family could all attend, even though it was a 14-hour drive for us to get to his hometown. So I needed to plan everything, down to the last detail, over the phone. My family was flying in from Norway, so they RSVP'd before I ever sent invitations. I end up having to call each and every guest repeatedly to find out if they are coming, while feeling crazy because everyone in his family is like, "Oh, don't worry so much." Frankly, I wanted to know if I was going to need place settings and food for 150 people or 75. You don't get a refund if the guests don't show, after all, on the day of the wedding. Which I received maybe 80 RSVPs. Well over 100 people show up, then are upset because there is no assigned seat for them, and because extra tables and chairs need to be set up. Additionally, his family is ultra-conservative Christian, and the highlight of the wedding was a family friend cornering me and saying, in a very loud, precise tone one might use for a deaf, mentally disabled child, "I love your people." I'm like, my dad, desperately searching for my husband to rescue me. "I love the Jews. They are God's chosen." At which point I cut her off and say, "Oh, I think there is," and leave, not even bothering to come up with a reason. We had little tartlets for dessert, as I'm not fond of cake. They were on a lovely table, at least 20 feet from the food. His family just started eating them. No worries about waiting for the bride and groom. They acted like I was crazy for asking them to not eat them until we were ready for the traditional dessert feeding ceremony. The guests immediately started to depart after eating. My husband and my family were the only people who danced. Oh, and the best part? The town we were to be married in changed the licensing requirements to include both birth certificate and social security cards, in addition to our driver's licenses. After we traveled there, passports were no longer accepted as form of ID, so my husband and I had to elope in a field 300 feet from the church in another county an hour before the ceremony. TLDR. I got 99 problems but a B ain't one. My husband and I got married a month before our actual wedding. Just for background info, the night before the wedding, at the rehearsal dinner, he broke up with me in a text message. Told me to pack my crap and get out by Monday. We were already technically married. I was running on 3 hours of sleep and nerves. This was after he was so drunk he could barely recite the vows during the rehearsal. He'd been ignoring me for about a week up until that point. I went to speak to his stepfather about the text I received, only to have him blame everything on my mother, whom he called crazy, to my face. And I have no idea how she was relevant or what she is to be blamed for, to this day. This started a huge fight between families. I mean, adults screaming obscenities at each other in public while I stood in a corner and cried on my best friend's shoulder because I was so embarrassed and disappointed and disgusted. My husband was screaming at anyone who would listen about how terrible I was. My father, who did 20 plus years in the army and is retired, later told me that he was so angry that he felt he was experiencing PTSD. He is 61 years old. I have never seen his eyes look so dead, and I'll never forget how violently he shook. I felt like I had aged 10 years that night. I was so worried my dad was going to have a heart attack or a stroke. I'm tearing up just typing that. My parents paid for everything. The wedding venue, decorations, a DJ, the food, bridesmaid stuff, groomsman stuff, my dress, hair, makeup, everything. They shelled out more than $12,000 for me to have my dream wedding, only to be ruined because I married an butthole with a personality disorder. And I don't mean that in a haha, what a jerk way. This dude has some serious issues that I should have not handled by looking the other way because he was pleasant 50% of the time. If even that. And no, I'm not blaming myself. Did I mention his 7-year-old daughter witnessed all of this? Because she did. I will also never forget her asking me when we were gonna have the wedding again. I can't imagine what she told her mother. People, if someone constantly says their exes were C, and no one treats them right, and everyone is in butthole, they are the problem, not you. Run while you can. Anyway, I'm still kind of bitter, mainly because it was humiliating and so much money was wasted. I had to send all the gifts back. People were embarrassed for me. People traveled to come share what was supposed to be a special day with me. After a while, all the pity started making me angry. My therapist had a field day with that. I still had the party. It just went from being a wedding to my mom's incredibly expensive graduation party. I'm glad it was an open bar too. I drank a lot of bottles of champagne that weekend. Beautiful, beautiful venue. It looked like a mansion. I never want to see it again. Not my wedding and it wasn't quite ruined but very much a huge mess. Last year my aunt got married to her high school sweetheart after 20 years. I took the night off of work so I could drink and have a good time with everyone. The reception was at their house in the country. They are doing quite well for themselves and had a lot of lawyers and doctors attend, so you know there would be expensive gifts. They locked their house about an hour after the reception started and everyone was there. only leaving the house unlocked for their wealthy guests to go inside and leave their belongings and gifts out of the elements. The night went as planned until my new uncle decided to show up at my house a week later. Apparently he had received large cash gifts of $15,000 and up, and somebody decided to steal it. He interrogated me but not harshly. I got the feeling he was just asking me man to man since I'm young, if I knew anyone at the wedding who might do such a thing. Of course I didn't. A week goes by and suddenly my entire family stops talking to me. He lost his crap and told my aunt that she could either keep the marriage or she could continue talking to me and my mother who was also at the wedding, then resulting in a divorce. He made her choose between her immediate family or her marriage. She chose her marriage. I used to be pretty big into tech but I'm not so tech savvy anymore. Whoever took the money disabled their security system, cameras and all and set it up so it wouldn't record for 48 hours, thus letting them steal the money with no way to prove it. According to him, because I used to be so tech savvy and am currently poor and struggling, he believes that is 100% chance that I stole the money, with constant insults about less wealthy folk always being thieves and not working for their own crap. Threats of breaking into my apartment and cutting off my hands for what he fully blames me of doing, and tons of other horrible things. I'm an honest guy and I would never do such a thing, especially to my own family. Come to find out, he had a really sketchy guy at his wedding that has been known to steal in the past. A week later, this guy abandoned his business, home and fled to another state. Nobody has since blamed that guy or even raised an eyebrow. Just blaming us because of our current financial situation. Not a good time. Yet, sometimes the shittiest things are done by people when they know they have a good scapegoat to pin it on. And unfortunately you were perfect at the time. I'm sorry that people are buttholes. I wouldn't leave this alone. And I would mention Mr. Shady Thieving McFuckface's name as often as possible to anyone who knows your family. My mother, who has mental health problems, got increasingly upset as the attention from the family was taken from her. It escalated to her barricading herself in her apartment, refusing to take her diabetic medication or eat anything, followed by taking all of her medication at once and then calling for emergency ambulance 4 days before the big one. The doozy is that the person who answered the call was my fiance's mum, mother-in-law-to-be, who was working at the call center and was nothing but professional whilst they got my mum assessed and well sectioned. She signed herself back out the night before the wedding citing it as a reason and then continued to cause merry havoc for attention for the whole thing. Highlights include shouting at the hairdresser, introducing herself with a shout "I'm the mother of the bride, who are you" to all, changing all the tables and seating arrangements 2 hours before the reception, refusing to state if she would be at the wedding. She lived opposite the church, people saw her peeking out of her curtains, being forced to come, being late and loudly complaining that she didn't have a good view from the front, as I was walking down the aisle after waiting for her to be seated, commenting rudely on people's outfit choices, refusing to smile for photographs, asking if the problem with my corset making me lightheaded on my dress was because I was too fat, in front of everybody who had just gone quiet for a speech at the reception, signing the guest book Mother of the Bride and addressing it only to me and not my husband, looking after guests of mine who were staying at her house for the night after by forcing them all to eat full breakfasts at 6 a.m. before they left, then complaining when their drunk hungover vomiting kicked in, picking us up for a drive on the morning after of our wedding and then taking us back to the reception hall and forcing us, as newlyweds, to help clear the bin bags, wash the dishes before the caterers came to pick them up etc etc. Feigning another self-harm attempt for attention after the honeymoon forcing me to spend my second week married with her in a clinic rather than with my husband. Sounds like you might have to just walk away from that one. If she won't get the help it's only going to get worse from here. Trust me on this. I know from experience. Next it'll be your kid's birthday parties stealing all her hard-earned attention away. Reddit. What is the worst wedding you've ever been to? What made it bad? The bride's aunt died on the dance floor while dancing. I was at a wedding where the groom's mother died during the reception. She wasn't at the reception. She was at the hospital, end stage of some cancer, and wanted them to keep their date so she could see the wedding. She watched through an iPad and then died. You want to kill a wedding? Put speeches an hour after dinner and have that happen for 3 hours. I think speeches started around 8 p.m. By the time the video tributes and the people talking about how great everyone is ended, it was 11 o'clock and everyone was just done. Not a lot of time to dance and socialize left over when the venue was closing at midnight. I was feeling sick, so I should have left sooner. Went to one that was the same thing. Big Italian Catholic wedding. 8-9 speeches through a 5-course dinner, while the bar was closed. The second that bar opened at like 10 p.m. people went nuts and got way too drunk way too fast. My best friend's wedding. She should never have married her husband. She is only with him because she doesn't think she can do better and no one else had really expressed interest. It was painful to watch her just lock herself into this darkness nihilation of self. I could see she even knew that's what was happening, somewhere deep inside. So many things happened which made it clear what was happening and even why. To bullet the despair, she spent the evening before with my husband and I talking about any guy she had ever had an interest in or flirtation with. It was like she was mourning all of her lost chances. No excitement, no mention of her husband-to-be. We jokingly, but not that jokingly, offered to just take her home with us. 6 hours away, she had no plans for getting ready the next day. Asked me at 10 p.m. to do her hair and makeup and arrange for the photographer to come to my hotel to document this. We also drove her to the wedding. Neither I nor my husband, her second best friend, were invited to be in her wedding party. It was strange, and so many people the next day would say, "Oh, you're her best friend. She talks about you all the time and look confused." Her matron of honor and bridesmaid were her husband's best man's family. They did not contribute to helping her get ready. It was like she didn't want us, the people who care about her, involved in this. Her parents had not been in touch for days and came 15 minutes late to the ceremony, never calling her beforehand. She had clearly learned her lack of value at home. His vows were mostly jokes for the audience. Loving her was never mentioned. Despite her asking him not to, he violently smushed the cake in her face. I helped her clean up. It was deeply up her nostrils, in her hair, in her eyes. Bridal maids tried to take pictures while laughing until I menacingly threw them out of the bathroom. It took me a while to make her vaguely presentable again. I offered again to just take her with me, far less jokingly. This time she was quiet and a little teary but did not respond. Best man's speech was about her husband mostly, with a story about how clumsy she is. I had to walk outside. My husband had to calm me down as I cried and yelled about it all, before people heard me. In the end, this was her choice. She spent the following 10 years so far feeding the worst, saddest parts of herself. She's become completely self-involved. I guess she needs to because no one else in her life is taking care of her. We haven't actually spoken in about 3 years, though she emails with my husband again, about herself only. She still calls me her BFF on Facebook and refers to my daughter as her niece, though my daughter doesn't know her at all. Thank God they never had children. I know they haven't had sex in at least 4 years. It was a wedding, but it felt like watching someone commit suicide. This was the most painful read in here to me. This is odd, but I am going to say mine. This was because of my wife's family. We wanted to keep the wedding very small. We were very young and some thought we were too young to get married, so this was the reasoning for keeping it small. I had my parents, brother and 4 friends. My wife invited her parents, brother and grandmother. Her grandmother took it upon herself to invite the entire side of my wife's family. We had over 100 unexpected guests that acted as if they were insulted that they had to be there. The good news is, my wife kicks butt, going on 15 years. A coastal wedding, in England, in January. The weather here is unpredictable at the best of times and the bride and groom decided to have their wedding at a castle right by the sea. Of course, it being January, the weather was atrocious. High winds coming directly off the sea and pea rain all day. It was freezing and the reception was in a marquee. There were very few heaters. I remember I specifically bought a new outfit for this wedding and was able to wear it again to the next one because I didn't take off my coat the entire time. It was hideous. I was at a dry wedding where the main theme was books. You were assigned to read a book prior to the wedding and were sat with people who read that same book to create conversation. Interesting idea. but a majority of people aren't going to do it. People were also purposely not put with people they knew, in attempt to make people socialize with others. Basically all we did is make a few sentences about how we didn't read the book, and left after being served an inedible dinner and headed to a bar. It was actually a really nice wedding, but it was an outdoor venue and it was unseasonably cold and it was raining. The venue where the wedding was held was outdoors, but it was like a huge covered patio, like even enough for the 120-150 guests to have seats under the roof. Anyway, instead of the seasonal average of like 65-70, we had 45 with wind and rain. Even if my tux with the jacket and all, it was chilly. The bridesmaids were shivering. The rain was blowing in because the patio was covered, but there weren't walls or anything. I love the idea of outdoor weddings, but I don't think I'd do it. I've been to 4 and only once has had the weather be cooperative. Ugh. I had friends get married in a forest. It was a stretch of meager woods between 2 cornfields. Mosquitoes galore. We had to sit on logs that were covered in damp moss. The mud was ankle deep in places, and the ceremony was inaudible due to a tractor plowing the field. They served food out a charming old cottage that was actually a rotting former chicken coop that the groom literally dragged in from elsewhere. The entire event was a nightmare. Went to a low-cost wedding. It wasn't the low budget that made it bad, but several things stemming from that. 1. They never specified that it was a casual wedding to anyone other than close friends and family. The invitations were pretty fancy looking, so I went out and bought a simple yellow sundress because I didn't have anything nice to wear at the time. I showed up overdressed. Most people were in t-shirts and dirty jeans. The other 1/3RD were more dressed up than the entire wedding party. 2. It was at a public park. It was crowded and there were dogs crapping everywhere and 1 couple in a very loud argument that you could hear across the park. 3. The reception was held in this tiny community room you could rent. It stunk like cigarettes. Most of the guests left the ceremony and went directly to the reception, because that's what the invitation said to do. After an hour passed without the bride or groom showing up, some caterers wheeled in some food and left. No one wanted to start eating before the bride and groom showed up, so the food just sat there getting cold. Another hour went by without the couple showing up, and eventually people got hungry enough to just say frick it and serve themselves. I'm just being honest when I say the food was absolutely disgusting. Vienna sausages in a now cold, sweet sauce, wilted veggie platter, cold canned chili. There also wasn't nearly enough food for all the guests they invited, so by the time the people in the back of the line got up there, nothing was left. 2 more hours passed before the bride and groom finally showed up. So that's 4 hours we were all sitting in this tiny, stinky room, with no music, no dancing, no nothing. 4 hours. Once they got there, the bride and groom just went over to their table and sat there. It became apparent that nothing was actually planned for the reception other than those 3 cold trays of food for 50 plus people. At that point, me and the group of people I came with decided to say congrats and leave. I don't even know why we stayed for so long. And yes, they are still happily married 10 plus years later. It was just a very poorly planned budget wedding. See, this is why I keep telling my mother that putting casual on our invites is a bad idea. She thinks of casual as a nice dress or slacks and a button-up shirt. I'm trying to get her to understand that casual these days means jeans. Probably my cousin's wedding. It was nice. There was nothing wrong with the wedding itself. But a lot of people were very confused by their relationship. It doesn't seem like they are in love. They could be 2 strangers on the bus. That's how much chemistry they have. It just didn't seem like they were right for each other and just got married because they felt like it was the next step. I talked to my sister about it the other day and turns out that a few months after they got married, my cousin asked our aunt, her mother, how she could get an annulment. But then a week later she found out she was pregnant. They're still together today. She's due this winter. Anyone knows she talked to her mom about it except me, my mom and my sister. I don't even think her husband knows. A sibling's wedding. It was a shotgun wedding, with the bride looking like a 7 months pregnant satin sausage, the groom drunk off his butt, despite not being legally old enough to drink. The ceremony being performed by the local Indian amongst the motorcycle gang the bride's dad belonged to, while the groom's mother and stepmother, who previously had restraining orders against one another, took a time out from there on. Going few to share shots out of the same flask, at a VFW hall off a major highway. Did I mention there were turkey vultures circling the building as we arrived? ETA. Spelling. This is one of those weddings you just have to get drunk and laugh. Oh man, this one is easy. It was on a beach on a day where the wind decided it wanted to make a point that it was boss. Wind coming off the ocean tends to cut through clothing really easily, and this was an outside wedding at night. Ceremony starts. The microphone they are using is straight static and no one can hear a thing the groom say, and it's just loud ear-piercing static. Once the finish and they are about to walk down the aisle to take pictures, the groom's brother run up there and grabs the mic and says, "Wait everyone, I have something to say." Gives a 30-minute sermon about God's will. Neither of these people getting married are religious. They go and take pictures. It takes 2.5 hours. It starts to become nighttime and everyone is in dress clothes waiting for the pictures to finish up. Still no food and everyone is starving and freezing to death. Then finally it was food time. Apparently the catering company drove all the food pre-made from hours away. It consisted of white rice, salad, mashed potatoes and the driest unsalted chicken you would get from El Pollo Loco. At least we would get cake. I was wrong. They brought out little cheesecake bites that were cut into little squares. I ate one and knew the gig was up. It was the telltale sign of Sara Lee cheesecake. These caterers seriously charged these people to cater their wedding and went and got $8 cheesecakes from the store and tried to pass it off. It was kind of crazy and I left. I was too cold to be out there during that. The brother religious sermon part is the exact reason I plan to elope. Went to my cousin's wedding in November in New York. That took place in a barn with no heating whatsoever. Everyone was freezing their asses off. The bride's dead father had recorded a message for her. She didn't know about it. They had to stop the wedding for an hour while she cried. The bridesmaids cried with her. 10/10 worst wedding I've ever been to. Also, the food was mediocre. That message from her father could have been sweet, but in hindsight, maybe in private before the wedding. My fiancé's brother got married earlier this year. The married couple in question have a tendency for executing 85% of the plan and leaving the rest to other people to figure out. I was one of the groom's men, and between his mother and myself, we became the last 15%. He wanted every groom's man to drive from where we were staying to the venue, a barn, separately because we all have cool cars and it will look cool for us to arrive in a convoy. I responded with questioning if the venue allowed cars to stay overnight. I knew the guest count and the amount of alcohol he brought, so I knew it was going to be one of those weddings. He said probably. Normal wedding stuff. Nice event. Bartenders have the heaviest of pours. People are starting to get really drunk. Towards the end the bartender starts handing entire bottles to attendees to get rid of it. Groom was double fisting wine bottles at one point. 10 p.m. The venue owners asks me and my soon-to-be mother-in-law why we haven't started cleaning up yet and when she was going to get her final check. Come to find out, not only had the couple not paid the final payment, they declined the cleanup fee, saying the groom's mother will handle that and never told anyone else about it. The mom obviously loses her mind and sends me to go find the groom because explanations are needed. I find him face down in a field surrounded by a pool of his own vomit with the other groomsmen trying to pick him up. He's a big boy at 6 feet 5 inches 260 lbs. I get him up and carry him back to the barn where his buddies nurse him back to life. I come back to report to his mom, who is furiously cleaning up. Needless to say, my report did not help her fury. Come to find out, they absolutely refused to allow cars to stay overnight at the venue, so after we finished cleaning, brought the groom back to life, had his mom write a check. We then spent the next 2 hours getting drunk folks and cars to the various hotels they were staying at. TLDR. If you're going to get trashed at your wedding, make sure you get all 100% of the plan in place, not 85%. Just reading this stressed me out. Whoa. It's a toss-up between the one where the bridal and groom part Y took a 5.1/2 hour detour between the ceremony and the reception for photos. A reception where no food was to be served prior to their arrival, with only a cash bar that also wouldn't serve until their arrival. And a totally dry wedding where the groom put a large cash gift from one of the bride's family members under his plate, only to forget until after the reception was cleaned up. Q. queue myself and several groomsmen inside a dumpster emptying and searching every bag in vain hopes of finding the lost money while the bride literally wept and wailed in the groom's arms. Went to a wedding once where the church service was noon to 1, and the reception was at 5, so we all went to the bar for 4 hours. Yay day drinking and fancy clothes. Parents of the bride were divorced and it was clearly not amicable. The bride didn't seem to have much backbone, so instead of telling them to put aside their crap, they ran amok. She walked down the aisle with her natural dad, but then her in-law dad stood with her at the altar. She had to do 2 separate father-daughter dances to 2 complete songs. The bio dad was hooked up with a loud trashy girl a good 15-20 years younger than her bio mom, so she decided to wear a low-cut dress that looked more for nightclubbing while the ex-wife stared daggers at her all night. It was most awkward 4 hours of my life. I've never been to a bad wedding, but I've been to weddings with bad moments. One of the worst was a Catholic wedding where the priest was cracking sexist jokes, covering horrible stereotypes. He talked for almost 30 minutes, and it was like a terrible stand-up show. He said things like, "As we all know, men and women are different. Women love shopping, and men love working with their hands. So men, when your wife goes shopping and buys you new stuff, just know that's what women are like. I mean, women. Am I right, men? When you come home from work and the kids want to play, and your wife wants a break, remember she's been home with them all day and need a break too. Men and women's brains are different. While men's brains are organized and logical, women's brains are like a bowl of spaghetti. So when you're having communication problems, just remember you love spaghetti and it makes sense to her." My husband and I were trying really hard not to laugh. Other than that, it was a lovely and super fun wedding. They sure know a lot about women, those Catholic priests. My brother's wedding. My parents and I have helped him through a lot of trouble in his life, prison, addiction, etc. He's clean and clear now, but I don't think he's ever understood what those years did to our family, and in typical white people fashion we never talk about it. His wife was wedding crazy, so it was all about her, which is fine, except her family had all the front tables. We were stuck down the back behind his rehab family. They had 3 hours of speeches where no one thanked or acknowledged my mum or dad, who had given them $20,000 for the wedding. We were then the last table to get to go to the buffet, by which time nothing was left. Oh, and of course there was no alcohol. My husband and I went through McDonald's on the way home. It just showed me that people never change. He's still an idiot. Now he's just an idiot with a wife. This one made me really sad. Your poor parents. Went to a couple's wedding who were both on their second wedding. The dude was rich, so everything was pretty nice. Except they decided a DJ wasn't needed. She made a playlist from YouTube and had that playing. The levels on all the songs were different. We had to wait for crappy Wi-Fi to play or load the songs, and someone had to keep changing the playlist when it finished. But that wasn't the worst part. More than half the songs were Pitbull. He was on every playlist, sometimes in a row, and songs were repeated. I should add in that they definitely had the money for it, as they had a guy playing guitar the whole time. No singing, just acoustic guitar while pictures were being taken. We decided against a DJ in favor of sorting the music out ourselves, but we had the good sense to use Spotify and download all the music ahead of time. Spent ages putting those playlists together and everyone loved the music. Can't imagine just playing stuff from YouTube. The mind boggles. I'm going to say my cousin's daughter's wedding. It was in Labor Day weekend and it felt like the hottest day ever. First of all, I'm not a fan of people having weddings on a holiday weekend, but whatever. Not why this was bad. We drove an hour to get to this barn in the middle of bumfrick nowhere. All the chairs were set up in this field in the beating sun. The service was about 45 minutes and I thought the groom was going to pass out. He was 300 pounds and had the suit jacket with the vest still on. We finally made it through the service and we got into the barn for the reception. No fans and no air conditioning. It was 100 people crammed into a barn in 98 degree weather. This was the barn's first wedding with everything brand new. My mother went to sit down and the chair split in half. Thank God my uncle didn't sit there like he wanted to, because he had just gotten major back surgery and the ambulance would have had to come and find this barn in the middle of the woods. My mom, my dad, my uncle, and myself went to sit under the shade of an apple tree until dinner was served and then got the heck out of there. It would have been a beautiful wedding if it wasn't the same temperature as heck. I always cringe when I get an invite to a summer wedding. I don't deal with the heat at all. Sitting in a suit jacket in really hot weather is about the last thing in the world I want to do. My brother's wasn't bad, but it was kind of annoying. It was held in a place where no microphones were allowed, due to the presence of tropical birds who would be upset by them, and the registrar who was doing the service had no concept of vocal projection. So we were just sitting there desperately trying to make out what she was saying so we could follow. I look grumpy in every photo due to straining myself to hear, and I was in the second row. We were essentially just watching a woman's lips flapping while my sister-in-law was wearing a nice dress. So I worked weddings at a hall in high school and I have a few. Shotgun wedding between a couple 17-year-old kids. They clearly didn't want to get married and their relationship was only physical. It was super cringy when they tried to do a toast but couldn't give the bride and groom any champagne. Yugoslavian couple. Yugos always have crazy weddings. They put the invites on the radio. Everyone from the community is there, you see the regulars. Well, the groom had a little too much booze forced on him by the old cognac drinkers and was sloppy as frick. The bride was giving him crap and he tried waving her off but ended up slapping her. Not sure if intentional or not. Bride's brother pulls out this custom engraved silver Beretta and puts one through the groom's shoulder. That was a long night. Another one, the husband gets up at the reception and announces that since he caught his new wife cheating on him with her maid of honor, again, he was having the marriage annulled. The mother of the bride started bitching the bride out over being a lesbian and how this guy was supposed to be their meal ticket and why couldn't she just have made it work. Bonus super sad story. Couple had everything booked for a wedding renewal on the 50th anniversary. The husband passed in his sleep the night before. They still had the reception because deposits paid and guests invited, but the tone changed considerably. For like half a second I thought the Yugoslavian and lesbian bride weddings were the same wedding. Fancy wedding at an award-winning restaurant. Groom was head chef. Maybe 100 or so guests. Stoked to eat some great food. We show up, realize they had the wedding itself on a boat an hour earlier with only a dozen or so of the closest guests. Kinda weird walking in and seeing the bride in her dress just schmoozing with everyone, but cool. Whatever floats your boat. LOL. Open bar. Everyone grabs their drinks and starts to get a bit tipsy. Food starts coming out. Everyone is lined up buffet style. Four of those hotel pans of food come out and are quickly emptied. The rest of the crowd, maybe 60-70 people, wait around in line for 10, 15, 20 minutes. Most sit back down or grab another drink. Another half hour passes. People get more drunk. Food still isn't coming out. Bride, groom, and family seem completely unfazed. There was a cheese meat board, but everything was gone in the first 10 minutes except for a giant wheel of parmesan, which people started hacking at desperately with forks. Flash forward 2 hours. Everyone is completely trashed and angry, confused AF. Still no food. We're in a restaurant. The groom is a chef. What is happening? A drunk 13-year-old girl stole my hat. We went to Taco Bell. 6 months later, the bride messages me on Facebook asking if my now husband and I would like them to cater our upcoming wedding. LOL. It was my brother's wedding. There were a lot of trashy and classic things. But in retrospect, what really made it bad was that it foreshadowed a lot of bad. At his own wedding, he stole his thunder by announcing they were pregnant after hiding it to that point, and did it minutes before the ceremony for everyone to hear. Bride looked pee through the entire thing. I'm pretty sure she didn't approve. I don't just mean the ceremony, I mean the entire night. Announced during his speech that whole table of buttholes who are RSVP'd and didn't bother to show up, and he pointed to a table no one would have noticed. They are wrong. I will be a great husband, the best husband, and the best father. They will see. So yeah, he walked out on her when the baby was something like 2 months old to be with another girl he knocked up who was something like 6 months pregnant. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.